Welcome to Tabletop Gaming Guild. Tabletop Gaming Guild is all about the experiences, memories of playing tabletop games with friends that families can create. And today we are learning Apiary, which is an excellent worker placement game that came out recently. And I'll go through a quick run through. I believe everybody's watched a how to play or has a rough idea how to play, but apparently James has it. But that's all right. So, standard worker placement on your turn. You can either place a single worker or retrieve all your workers. Now, all your workers have numeric values on them. You will start with number workers equal to what it says on your faction mat. So on mine, you can see I start with a level 2 worker and 2 level 1s, and the remaining one goes next to the board. So, how do I change it to a level 2? We'll find out.
You just like right click and then probably a set value.
Actually, you can just hover over it and hit the number.
Ah, that also
Well,
helps.
that makes it even easier.
As
Okay.
James fails at TS.
You will also start with some resources shown on your faction. It's the one that's in the slightly brighter color. So, and I start with a water and a pollen, I think it is, yes.
Twizzler. We said Twizzler.
No, that's plant fibers, Twizzler.
Okay.
All right, so let me get my starting here. I got
So if I get a
two.
water, the next one has a brown and a Twizzler. So which one would it be?
You take the one that's the brighter
The
color.
brighter. So that for
The
your case,
Twizzler.
Correct.
Yes.
yes, the plant fiber,
The
yes.
plant fiber, yes.
I'm gonna
And
call it Twizzlers and annoy you all
wait,
night.
here, James, where's your fourth B?
I put them up there because I only get three, right?
Correct.
I
Yeah.
can't, I
Oh
don't know
yeah,
how I
okay.
change the other one to a two.
Mouse over it and then push the number two on your keyboard.
Oh, wow. It just flashed
Okay.
out and
All
then
right, and then
I
also
do.
put them in your active pool here. It kind of will make it the pool will kind of make matter later on
Okay.
here.
Yes, that's true. Okay. You'll also notice on your faction board, the reason why some of your circles have more than one resource is because those are the possible resources you can store at that spot. You cannot store anything that you
Ooh.
don't have storage spots for.
Okay.
So most cases it'll let you store water, fiber or pollen, and there's spots that'll allow you to do honey or whatever the
Wax.
other resource, wax, yes. Okay, so let's go through the various worker placement sections. The number you place on each worker placement section is very important. We'll talk about explore. So, in the explore section, if you place a worker there, just let me grab my worker just for example. So, whenever worker is placed, it's always placed in the, in this case, the left or small spot. If there's a worker there, it gets pushed to the right spot. If both places are full, the one on the right gets pushed off the board back to the player, and we'll talk about what happens then later. Okay, so what you do in Explore is you will total the number value of workers in both spots. So another player's worker can actually help you to increase the strength of your action. In the explorer action, you are simply going to move the queen, the number of spots equal to those combined, and then you will take this favor token, flip it, get the reward, and take it. And then you will take one of these planets. You will immediately get some resources. I'm not able to pull a planet, but yeah, if you can pull one, just show. Okay, so what will happen is sometimes they'll have resources printed on them, and you'll get that resource. But if they have open spots like this one does, you get to pick a resource and fill one open spot every time somebody uses that planet. So, and then you get that resource as well. So you could get multiple resources from a single planet.
How do you
That
show
could.
you own the planet?
You don't own the planet, you are just activating it. So when you travel to it, you get whatever resources the planet gives you, and that's your main way of getting resources.
Okay. Yeah, some planets will have a printed on resource, and some of them have like different varying amounts of ones. Like, you know, could have like three blanks. So, I mean, it'll start with just one resource, but yeah, every time someone goes there, it'll have more options.
Some will also have text at the bottom. That text is only relevant if you use a 4-strength worker to activate that action.
Well, it's the combined, so could it be 2/2s?
No.
In that case, no.
Okay.
It's, you have to, your specific one has to be a strength 4.
Yeah, okay. It's basically every action, if you place a 4 on it, gets a special thing whenever you place a 4. So 4s are special.
Yep. Let's go to this advanced section. This is the section that allows you to get new tiles for your hive. Expand your hive, basically. When you put it's the same functionality. When you put a worker in one of these advanced sections, you add the total of the workers that are there, and obviously push workers as well if you need to. And the total is which column you can choose from. So right now, I'd have a 2 because there's a +1 printed. So I can only pick from the first column of the farm, the green tiles. If I were to go below, I can pick from the first column of either the research or the development tiles. When you pick one of these, you pay the cost in the bottom in resources. And you immediately get the reward shown up top.
And that's you a resource can get of your choice?
Yep.
Yes, in that case, a resource is your choice.
Well, and there's ways of the three main ones.
Yes. So not wax or honey. Just the other three. You can also get these resources again later in this case, but we'll show you that when you, that has to do with how, when you draw your workers back. And I'll talk to about that later. These also give you places to store resources in the future, and they are worth points at the end of the game. There are various effects that refer to the various symbols, the farm, recruit, and development, but the colors also can be used to refer to that. Research typically cost pollen and give you ongoing abilities. So once you have that unlocked in future, anytime you do the relevant action, you get that ability. Development are all instant effects. So you, for this one, you'd pay off a wax and you immediately gain a honey, 2 wax, or 2 whatever those seed cards.
Seed cards, yep.
Okay, when you buy a tile, it's going to go on to your player board. And to begin with, it has to be touching one of your 3 section of your faction. And then you build from there. You can build off of, it has to touch a previously placed tile or your faction mat. And you would get the resource shown in the spot, or sometimes it will unlock a one-time ability, depending on what your particular space faction is, or space hive thing. Okay?
And it has to go on a space, too. You can't just build off of your ship.
Correct. If you fill that up, you cannot place any more tiles until you build an expansion, which I'll show you in a little bit. We'll go on to convert, which is this section here. So this is basically where you go to trade. So the value of the token you put here is how many trades you can make. So you can trade 1 seed card in and draw a new one, trade 1 of your basic resources for any other, trade some basic resources for wax or honey. But if you place a level 4 worker there, you get to unlock one of these dances. You teach it, in which case you will draw, where did the little dance things go? I can't even. Are they up there? Here. I can't see them. Okay.
Somebody must have dragged them up there.
You will get to look. You can look through the entire deck of these and pick these. Oh, I can't even. You will get to pick them, the ones you want, and you can put them on the dance you want to activate. And that'll basically say, it's like, okay, if I were to do this, once I learn the dance, once I teach the dance, rather, I immediately get to do that action, which is spend a favor and a wax to get a honey. And for teaching the dance, you would put a cube on there to indicate that's yours. And anytime somebody else uses that, because now that's available for everybody, anytime somebody else uses that, you would get to advance on this Queen's Favor track. I know this is a lot, but we can walk you through the things as we go through it. But the key thing is that once somebody teaches a dance, it's available for everybody. It just takes one of your action values to be able to do that when you go to convert.
And if I remember right, you can just select any of those tokens that you want, right? Like, you don't just draw randomly. Yeah.
Yes, you can. Carve. You need to do a level 4 worker to go here, and you get to take one of these carve tiles, which are end game scorings that you often get you a lot of points.
Okay.
Grow.
There is a way to not play a 4 there, but that requires like getting specific recruits, and like there are a few things that let you break that rule.
Yes. Yeah, a lot of the rules can be broken with certain abilities and certain cards.
Yeah.
So, yes, the seed cards. Grow allows you to do these two actions as many times as you want, equal to the value of your drone that you put here. So if you do a 3-value drone, it would cost you 2 of its strength to do this bottom action, trade 2 resources for an expansion to your hive, which look like that once it loads, and that has to touch your hive. And now you can build onto those spots. Or you can spend 1 of your strength to spend a pollen to get one of your drones back from beside the boy that's hibernating.
Okay.
If you use a level 4 worker there, you can flip your faction tile and get the better version of it. Which, for all the starting ones, that's just, I believe, more points at the end of the game.
Yeah.
All the starting ones are basically, you have a certain type of tile next to your faction to get extra points.
Yeah, and the switch, I think you just changed the state to 2.
Yes, probably.
Yep.
Research. Research is how you draw the seed cards. I'll show you one just as an example. So, seed cards. When you draw them, you can draw cards equal to the value of the worker you put there, but you only get to keep 1 no matter how many you draw. You discard the rest. If you use a level 4 worker, you can also plant a seed card, which we'll talk about in a second. So all of these seed cards have 3 possible uses. 1 is just using it for a basic resource. And this one is you can use it for a one-time ability. Just discard it to do this effect that's in the text. Or if you plant it, which is using your level 4 worker, you get this end game scoring. So this one's straight 4 points at the end of the game if you plant it. When you plant, it goes under your mat. You see there's 2 spots available to begin with, so you can only plant 2 seeds at the beginning. If you've expanded your hive once, you can unlock this 3rd spot. If you've expanded twice, you can use this 4th spot. Okay. Those are all the action spaces. We'll talk about hibernation in a second, but we'll talk about if you get booted. So if you get knocked off and you're given your worker back, you then have a choice. You can either put it in your active pool and increase the value by one.
Ooh, I like that.
That sounds good. Put it in your landing area, which you do not increase the value when you put it in your landing area. The important thing about that is you only want to do that if you're planning to withdraw your workers. Because when you withdraw your workers, you take all your workers from their board and your landing area, and you get to activate any production from these farm tiles that you have on your board. Once one worker, each worker can activate one, and they cannot activate the same one that another worker activated.
Okay.
Yeah. So like,
so you,
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, we had like one person who kept on complaining. It's like, I never get to do my farm because his workers kept getting bumped and he never sent them to the bottom. He always just incremented and sent them to the top.
So,
makes sense. All right, so all we have left is the hibernation cone.
Yes. If a worker is bumped, but it's already level 4, you can still put it in the landing area. But if you try to put it in the activated pool, or try to retrieve it, it hibernates because you can't go above level 4. And hibernate means it goes back here to the unavailable area, but you also get to put one of your hibernation tokens into the hibernation comb and get the immediate reward.
It goes back down to 1 when it goes in the unavailable area?
Yes, it does. So at the end of the game, this hibernation area is going to be majority control, so that whoever has the most tokens is going to get 9 points.
Second, 4. Okay.
And the game end is triggered when either all of these hibernation cone spaces are full, or somebody has used all of their hibernation tokens.
Yes.
Just double check that. Yes. The other thing to talk about is we didn't really talk about this Queen's Favor. The primary way to get, there's a few ways to get Queen's Favor. Basically, you're going to be advancing as people do your dances, or some of your tiles will give you Queen's Favor, and that's just scoring at the end of the game.
Okay.
There's like the main thing, though, is whenever you're producing. Oh, yes. That's a huge part of getting Queen's Favor there. So, like, you have only so much storage. So if like you go, like you have 3 water, you can only store 3 water and you get 3 more water. Well, that doesn't just go completely away, because I mean, instead you get, basically you're donating it to the queen and you would get 3 Queen's Favor for that. So overproducing is a valid way of going up.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
And and you notice it starts out slow, but by the time you get to the 25th spot, that's 25 points at the end of the game.
Well, I think I'm ready to beat Peter, because we're on competition for losing normally.
That's right.
Although Peter may pull ahead and crush us all, in that case, I will not be competing with Peter. I'll be competing with someone else, but we'll see.
But I'm pretty sure it's going to be either James or me fighting for the bottom of the total pool here.
Pretty much.
Going for low man. Going for low man.
So I'm assuming, who was first? Was it Nathan or you, John?
It's me.
Okay.
And then, yeah, Nathan's second, and then Peter's third.
How do we know turn placement?
Actually, no, that's wrong. I'm sorry. It's just me, and then we go clockwise from there.
Okay, because I was like,
would have been really weird.
So actually, I did this wrong.
Fourth when he was right in between.
Yeah, I did this wrong. So I'm first. So that means that second player is actually
James.
James. So he gets down here.
Yep. Then Nathan.
Yeah. Yep. Then Nathan. There. Yeah. Because basically, you also get like, you get seeded points too.
That's right. So yeah. So hold a second. Everybody, I'm in the lead.
Yes.
Yeah. High five to Peter. We're gonna do it.
Do you want us to end the game right now?
Yeah, let's call it right now, guys.
Yeah, game's over. It's over. Nathan, Peter wins.
Nathan, thanks for teaching the game. I appreciate it.
All right, so we're going to start off with John taking his amazing move and not the spot that I want because he normally does that.
Yeah, I got to first kind of take a look to see what we got here. So we've got whenever you game one of the whenever you do advance, those cost one lat, wax less. So does that can it make it cost zero?
I would assume that in most of my games that when it does that, it can't cost less than zero, but it can make it cost zero.
Yeah.
I am fairly certain that's true.
I feel like that is the case too. Oh, there is something too on wiping out the market too. There was something for that. That happens. What?
Wait, does the market not get filled when you buy one?
It does. After you buy one, you immediately refill. But there are some cards
that allow you to wipe.
Oh, you mean wiping is then there's no more available to get.
He's like, I don't like any of these. Let's get rid of all of these ones and draw three new ones. I think, is it cards? Yeah. Oh, no, it's also down here. That's it.
Yes. That's true.
Yeah, those three, whenever you go and put your hibernation on those, will wipe out the relative market.
Okay. Well, that's not for a little bit. So yeah. We're good.
And also, the thing is, though, some things can move and also get discarded. So, like, if you cover up a bonus, you get rid of that tile somehow, and you can then get that bonus again.
So, just real quick, I'm going to double check. At the start of the game, we do not start with any cards in hand?
No.
No.
Okay. All right.
I have a seed card. I stole it. No, I'm kidding. I don't have it.
All right.
I need advantages.
Lots of us are learning. If you draw a card, you don't understand it. Go ahead and ask. We'll pretend we don't know you have a card.
No, I don't care. I'm good. I'll just see it. It's fine.
So right now I'm trying to decide where I want to go first here. Because do I go for just getting more resources? None of these.
Now, do they? When you let's say he goes here and he picks up this one. When it replenishes, do these move down and a new one comes in, or it just goes over?
Everything slides to the left. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
And if you have a three here, you can't take from the two column. You have to take the three column.
You can. You basically, that's your maximum you can take up to.
Okay, just making sure.
Actually, it even gives you a little nice, if you have a three, that's why that little box covers the two and the three.
Okay.
All right. That's what I'm trying to decide. But I don't have any pollen, unfortunately. So you want it's gonna be boring.
Oh, that's right, they cost on the top.
Yeah, they cost on the bottom there, yeah. So yeah, these guys cost pollen.
Oh, I got a Twizzler and water. What do you have? A Twizzler and water.
Yeah, a lot of people that's kind of a common starting one. The one that I played with before, I actually started with no resources. But instead I got a blue worker for free from the market. Which was kind of cool. Yep.
That's one of the non-basic factions.
Yeah.
Which some of them are pretty interesting.
Yeah. So, I think I'm going to start with just a boring old explorer. Yeah, because when I did that, I was like, oh, man, I started with like a bunch of stuff, so I actually did other things in that game. So,
you played a one in the explorer, so you get to move one space adjacent to the queen's ship, but not diagonal.
So I get a queen's favor. That.
So you go up one on that track.
Yep.
Then you're going to put a planet out.
Yep. And let's see what planet we got. Oh, we didn't shuffle this. That was the example we used. All right, here we go. Gentia. Okay. All right. So it has no resources on it, so I just basically pick one. Let's go with pollen. I want pollen on that one.
Why is there two slots?
In the future, if somebody goes there, they can put the second one on. Yep. And they get both resources.
And you get both resources.
Right now, you get a pollen.
Yeah, right now, I get a pollen. But if somebody goes back there, they will get that pollen plus whatever they pick.
Okay.
And you also, you can't, with the Queen's movement, if you had two movements, you can't be like, weep, weep. You can't, there's no backtracking.
You can't end, yeah, you can't end where you started.
Yep. No shimmying. All right, but that's my turn. Pretty
bog standard move, John.
Yep.
Well, I'm going to take my basic. I'm going to put my little onesie over here.
Okay.
And I think I'm getting this towel. So I think that for this towel, I need a Twizzler and a water. So
that's correct.
And
yeah, I'd lock your board. I would lock your board.
I'll allow you to do that for me.
All right, there you go. That's locked. And I'll go and lock your other one too for you.
You know me too well. So,
and I'll unlock it if you go and get to where you upgrade it.
So when I buy this, do I immediately get to produce two?
You get to produce one of any of the three basics.
And then later on, I might be able to produce. And then I place it.
Later on, that's just basically storage for those two water. So you're expanding.
No, I mean, later on, I can reproduce with that.
Yes.
Yeah. And where I place it, I get the resource. So what do I want is a question that I would like to answer. I know what I want. I'm going to put it on here on the water, which I think is legal.
Yep.
And then that would give me a water. And is one of the basic resources the pollen, the green, this?
Yes. Yeah, pretty much the...
So I can place that here. And I can't build off of this?
Yep.
You can.
I can? So I can keep covering these things?
Yep.
Okay. I'm good. I'm done. I got my water. Oh, wait. I have to move these down, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And we flip a new one over, and it's someone else's turn.
Man, we got some expensive ones out here.
Yeah.
I'm going to go straight in with my two.
Oh, down below. You getting that two research one? Yeah, two pollen.
Well, it's two pollen.
Yeah, it's two pollen.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah. Otherwise, I would have bought it already, too. Yeah.
It's a good one.
It's a good one. Yeah.
It is, but I don't have two pollen.
Yep.
I can get two pollen, which maybe that's what I want to do.
That might be a thing to do.
Okay. So, what I'll do is I will do the explore. So, I kick John over, and I get a two value explore.
So that means you can move up to two spaces.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And the place you end on is what you get your thing, right?
Yep.
Yes. So whatever this is.
Ooh, two water. That's not bad.
Two water. You do keep these.
Yeah, because I think there are sometimes. Oh, yeah, and it might be worth going and reading all the in-game scoring tiles down here, because that's usually where something like that might come up. Or sometimes some of the C cards. Yeah. Like if some of the C cards, if you plant them, might care about that too.
Okay.
So you get a Twizzler.
Twizzler, and I can choose a second.
Oh, so you're going to get two resources with that one?
Yep.
I will.
And also, this one has a special text on it too. So,
in fact, I'm. But you had to be a four, right?
Yeah, it had to be a four. You get to gain two more of your wild and 3 points if you spent your four to go there.
Okay.
Okay, so that was my turn.
All right, Peter, represent. Let's get there.
All right, so I will take... Let's see here. I'm going to use my two. And I'm going to go up here...
Yeah, it bumps me down.
...to the farm action, to advance.
Yep.
And on the farm side, and I bump James down, which gets me a three.
Yep.
So I will turn in my water and Twizzler. That's right, James.
That's right. We're doing it.
I said it. We're doing it. I'm going to pick up this second tile in the farm
area.
I'm going to scoot that on down.
Yeah, that's what I was going to get.
And then that's going to get me three on the Queen's Favor track, correct? Yep. So it jumps up to three there. And then I will place this over here on my ship somewhere. And it's got to be All touching. Right. It just has to be touching one of the three bits of the starter thing, right?
Yep.
And if I when I cover up a space, that's when I get the
bonus on there. Yep.
The bonus on that. All right, fantastic. So I will grab that, and I will grab a pollen for my resource. And then these get put away. All right, that was me. That's right.
All right,
well. Bump me.
No, I'm not bumping you. I'm bumping myself.
So when bump.
So that would make it set to two.
Yep.
And I'm placing my one here.
He's exploring again.
Yep. All right, you know what? I'm going to go here. So. And I get a wax. All right, that's good. That's something different. And let's see what planet I get. There we go.
Oh, that's you get Zingy.
Planet. Zingy. Oh, and that wasn't here. If you go and place your four on that one, you get to teach a dance and use it twice.
Wow.
All right, so that's giving me a pollen. And then, you know what? I feel like we need more water sources out here, so we'll get a water as well. So I get pollen and a water.
All right, so I'm going to make this super easy. Nathan gets bumped off, so he does his thing that he wants. And I'm going to explore for two. I put your guy up here on top of the board.
Yes. I don't have any farms, so I'm just going to turn them to a two.
Yeah. I'm going to move all the way over here, flip this up. Ooh, I get a point.
James has never been so much happier to get a point in a game.
No.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to take my token.
Hey, I just put myself on top of blue.
Yep.
Yeah,
that's fine. And James, guess what? I'm still in the lead.
That's all right, guys.
It's fine. As long as one of us.
Hey, look, all I know is that I'm losing and I'm in a bad spot here, guys. All right? So.
Oh, one thing I didn't mention is a minor thing.
Oh, wait, I can't store pollen.
Yes, you can.
Yeah, you can.
Where?
Oh, these, yeah, okay. Yeah, those store pollen ore.
Oh, hold on a second. At the end of your turn, you have to be able to store it, correct?
Correct.
Yes.
So when I got that pollen at the end of the last turn, I shouldn't have to put it back because I don't have a place to store pollen. Oh, no, I do. Never mind. I forget these do double duty there. My bad.
Okay. I also want to point out that at the end of the game, you get 8 points if you filled up your entire hive.
Yeah, right.
And all the additional sections are also worth 8 each.
Yep. Okay. Yeah, if you fill up any of them, yeah, they're all worth 8.
Got it.
Is all that right, me now?
Yep.
So we'll try to do what I tried to do last time and get this to cost to make things cheaper.
James, there's a spot to store these tokens on your board. I just threw it there for you.
Where?
Right here. The right side of your board for storing those exploration tokens.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, because there's really? Also, like, some of the cards will let you be like, here you go, activate one of your exploration tokens again.
You'll be like, you'll pick me because it'll be like 1 point.
Okay. That one goes away. And that's my turn.
All right.
Go away.
All right, so Nathan, here? You get to refill that recruit line.
Four per honey. Oof.
That might change what I want to do here in a second. We'll see.
Oh, wow. Gain one of those for free.
Whenever you build a tile adjacent to me, gain pollen.
I like that last one.
Yeah, the last one looks good. I like that one. I'm not a huge fan of this middle one here.
Did somebody take one? Oh, yeah. Somebody. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Nathan took one just now.
Yeah.
Whenever you gain one, also gain...
Yeah, did you spend both pollen for that one, Nathan?
I did, and I got one back because I placed it over a pollen.
Ah.
Really wild.
All right, so I'm going to take my one, and let's go ahead and let's bump John off the explorer track.
He walked away, but I put him on top of the board, so he'll know when he gets back.
Yep, that works. So then I get two spaces of movement, and we're going to go down and to the right. Ooh, I get three resources. Oh, look at that.
All right, that's a lame one. And you get three resources.
Planet.
And you get a Twizzler and another resource.
That is just what I'm talking about.
You're like five resources.
All the resources.
Peter's now rich.
Let's go ahead and drop that. And then the queen is on it. So yeah, so I get two pollen, two Twizzlers, and a water.
Mm-hmm.
Where's this go again? This goes down over here. Yeah, thanks. All right, two pollen. I said two pollen, two waters, and a Twizzler.
Two Twizzlers
and a water.
Yeah.
Two plant fibers.
Nope, Twizzlers.
Twizzlers.
See, this only works if you're clever enough to actually come up with things for all of them.
No.
It's a work in progress.
No, but here's the problem. So I do run into a problem, though, being that rich.
Yeah.
Is if I can't spend it and I can't store it, I'm going to lose.
Well, you do get queen's favors, right?
Yes. For each one you can't store at the end of your turn, you advance on the queen's favor track.
Yeah,
the end of the world,
but this is going to be the end of my turn because I can't really there's right because I get all those things, I place that, and then I just have to figure out what I want to do. So really, I went from having the possibility of five things to having just three things that I gained,
and two queen's favors,
and two queen's favors. Correct.
Well, if you chose a water instead of the pollen, you could have stored one more, but you might really want.
Do you
want
to switch that?
If I do it, done what now?
So on your planet, if you would have picked a water instead of your pollen, you would get it. You would be able to store that water. Do you want to do that?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Sure, if everybody's cool with me doing that,
do
real
it.
Quick.
Yeah, yeah.
Just okay. So we'll put the pollen back, which means one of these pollens goes back, which means the water goes out here.
That way, the only thing you're losing is a Twizzler.
And then I get a water. And yeah, and who cares about Twizzlers? Seriously. Yeah. So I put the Twizzler back in and get one queen's favor.
Yes. Yes.
All right.
And John's next. Right?
Yes, I believe John.
I'll put his guy
John
down
next.
Right beside him there.
Yeah.
So if I run out of people, because AKA no one got bumped, I can just do a recall on my turn.
Yep, you can do a recall. Any turn you want, you don't have to have all your people out.
But once all your people are out, you kind of have to do a recall at that point.
Hey,
right?
John.
Yeah.
All right. Guy got bumped. He's down there.
Okay. I'm just going to go and bump him up then. All right. Sorry about that.
Yeah, it's fine.
Just won a raffle, like $600 in lottery tickets. So.
Nice.
All right, so who's my turn?
Yeah, it's your turn. Yep.
I figured it might be, but I just wanted to. All right. Man, getting a free expansion seems nice, but getting that one is going to be difficult.
Ooh. You can't even get a free expansion, right?
No. Yeah, you have to have five. Yeah. So whenever you gain a board, also gain a card. Not bad. But whenever you build next to me, gain resources. That seems not bad, but yeah, and I have it there, and I can build off there. Yeah, that doesn't seem too bad. So, yeah. Also got two waters and a plant. Fiber. Yeah, there ain't nothing there for that. And I don't have any more storage, so yeah, I'm doing that then. And I could play my two or my two or my two, so I will play a two. And yeah, I think I'm gonna take the free pollen guy. That seems pretty good. I'm gonna drop him there. And that's gonna get me a queen's favor. And that's gonna cost me one of my pollen. All right, that's my turn.
Okay, I wasn't lucky like Peter. I didn't get all those resources on my turn, so I'm gonna bump my own guy, which I'll take care of in a second. And I'll go here. So this lets me go up to three spaces. Not that that matters. And we'll do one, two, three.
You don't have to move three. You can just move up to three, but yes.
It don't matter. So I got Queen's Favor. I would do the same. And I'm under blue, so that's one. Okay, then I get to put a planet out.
Ooh.
Oh my gosh, am I getting bad luck with this job?
Namey is kind of lame.
Oh, why? This is the second time I heard it. The first time I got a point, the second I got a queen's favor and one resource. And then Peter goes, he's like, I got 50 resources, sucker. And I'm like, what the heck? What the heck?
Here, you know what? Just because you love that exploration token there, I just want to make sure you got it.
James is mad. I'm liking this game now. It's all it takes. All it takes.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
board game designers, take note. If you make James mad, Pete's gonna love your game.
All right. So now it is Nathan's turn, I believe. Yes. And Nathan's bumping himself, and he's getting the one that I wanted. Aren't you? Aren't Probably. You?
Is he currently muted, or is he just not talking?
He's frozen.
I was muted.
Okay.
I want... Ooh, actually, I do want this one, but I can't afford it right now.
Horrible person.
I don't have two pollen, do I? I don't.
Yes!
Just so I'm getting this one.
Okay, fine.
I'm paying zero wax to get...
Oh, yeah, I forgot I have a wax.
Do I want to take two wax or do I want to take a honey?
Honey's or nice. Two seed cards.
I am going to take a honey. And I'm going to put it here.
Ooh, yeah, this one here lets you discard every exploration, as many exploration tokens as you want and gain a point for each one you discard.
And that costs me nothing. And I get my honey.
Don't forget to get your worker back, too. That got bumped.
Yep. And I'm going to make that a level 3 worker.
Yeah, figured.
No point in holding them if I don't have farms.
Yep.
It's Master Peter's turn. What are you going to do with all this luxury goods you have?
Well, so what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to take my one lone worker drone, and I'm going to go research. I'm going to grab a seed card.
Yep, so you just get draw one and keep one.
Yep, and my understanding with seed cards is you can play a card before and after you place your worker. So if I wanted to right now, I could play the card I just grabbed.
Yep.
Yes.
If I wanted to.
Yeah, some of them I think sometimes like affect a specific action, so you kind of react with them, but I don't think there's very many of those, if there are.
All right, so since we haven't really had a card out yet, I'm going to go ahead and put this one out for everyone to see so that we can talk it over real quick.
So I'm assuming you could do the top right, which gives you one of any good.
So it says...
That's basically you wipe these three here.
Which three?
The research, the blue one. So you.
Oh, it's the research tracks.
Yep. So yeah, refresh that display. And then you may purchase one for minus one pollen.
That's pretty cool.
So yeah,
you could plan it For end game power, 1 point per any resource
that you have. Yep. Yeah. Any one of the three.
Yeah.
Basic resources. Yep. Yeah.
Which could be a lot of points.
Yeah.
But he has to use a level 4 worker in that spot to be able to plant one from his hand, so he can save it for later.
Right.
But so to play this card, I would pay the cost of any one basic resource. No.
Basically, the card counts as one basic resource. So it's not a cost. It's just like, if you wanted to, you can always ditch a card as a resource, as doing like another action.
Oh, that's right. That's right. But if I played the card for its ability, I would refresh that display on the board and then purchase one of them for one less pollen.
Which could be free.
Which could be free.
Interesting. Okay.
And but you I would can have do to, that at any time.
Right, but I would have to refresh it first.
Yep.
You know what? Let's just do it.
All right.
Let's just do it now so we can see what happens. All right, so we're refreshing.
All right.
Now, these three don't get put back in, right? They're just gone.
Yeah. So, I mean, unless we somehow run out of tiles, I think we reshuffle them back in. But I don't think that that's going to happen.
All right. I don't think that's ever happened. So none of these are worth victory points.
No, most of them aren't.
Okay, that's good to know. I don't think I knew that.
Yeah, the only one that was like this one here. The power is not that, you know, interesting, usually then you get some points for it.
So this one here says convert, produce one wax for free. Is that any time I do the convert action?
Yeah, anytime you do the convert action, you get one free wax.
Okay. And then this one here is anytime I do the advance action, I may purchase from any column regardless of worker strength.
Ooh, that one is pretty cool.
Yeah. And right now,
so you can start grabbing them fives.
And right now, you are purchasing any of them from the display. So you also don't care about worker strength right now.
Well, right. Yeah, exactly. And I pay one less pollen. So they're all just one pollen purchase.
Yep.
And whenever you gain a hive expansion. Pay one resource to plant one seed.
Yeah,
which is pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty good. That means you don't have to put a 4 on research.
But I don't know how often I'm actually going to gain a hive frame.
Well, it's kind of like if you're gaining a hive frame, you can also make sure that you have a card that you want to plant at the same time.
Yeah, I think
like future planning more than anything.
That one requires a lot of planning.
Right. Convert. That's this one down here. In advance. May purchase from any column regardless of worker strength. I'm going to go ahead and grab that one, I think. It's tough. Like, I like the idea, though, of getting more wax for free.
Yeah, because wax is like one of the more expensive ones to get.
It is kind of, yeah. You know,
honey's
what?
Most expensive, but I mean, both of those are pretty strong. You can't go wrong with either of them.
I am going to go ahead and grab the convert one, I think. So I'm going to get that. I will pay one pollen for that. And then I just end up placing that. We refill that. I get rid of the card. So do we have a card discard space?
This goes there.
Yep.
On the board.
There we go. And I will place that hex on my board. I'm going to place that. Let's go ahead and place that. It's got to be touching. That's right. It's got to be adjacent to something I've already placed. Let's go ahead and go over here, and I will get one resource of my choice.
And make sure you're aware of your faction ability. So.
Yeah, I know.
Instance.
Yeah, at that point, I didn't have any option for it because I don't have any wax to purchase any of those yet.
Yeah, they can be hard to get sometimes.
Yep, but I'm working on it. So I'm going to go ahead and grab another Twizzler.
Twizzlers.
All right, that's me.
Yep.
So that's John. My goal is at the end of each of my turns, when John starts his turn, he goes,
That's my goal, too. I think it's a good goal.
I just do not like any of the options out here for me.
Then do something else.
That's just when you go exploring, because it's kind of random right now. You don't know what you're going to get.
Yeah, but going exploring is, like, definitely not.
We should research then. You should research so I can get one of my bees back and upgrade them.
I mean, you can also just, you can take the recover action too. I mean, that's an option.
It is, but I don't like it as much.
I don't understand.
Says the guy who has been bumped, I think, like 3 times already.
Yep. Sometimes that's not always good. Some, you know, I mean, it is for me at this moment. Yes.
Yeah. But... Yeah. Correct.
So when you recover, you can, and you return your bees back. For each bee you return, you can fire off one of your production things, but they have to be a different one per bee, or they can be the same one.
Yep. No, it has to be a different one per
bee. Different one, yeah.
Yeah, and this is all, I don't like any of this.
Well, you gotta pick something.
Yeah, I do. Because all those guys are too expensive, and I don't have any storage, and I can't buy more storage because it's all too expensive.
Wait, here. It's a little violin just for you.
Sweet.
I broke it. My fingers are too large. I'm so sorry. Mm. I can't do it.
So, yeah, here you go, Peter. You get your shit back. I am going to do a research. I'm going to draw two. Keep one of these. Okay. Interesting. That one might be better for endgame.
Too ballin'. Can I get to place that somewhere?
I'm gonna discard that one.
I kicked you. I booted your guy.
All right. Yeah.
James, are you doing the thing that I hate? You're doing your turn while John's still doing his turn.
He's discarding.
I was discarding a card.
Not my problem.
I know. No, I see how it is.
Yeah.
He can't discard right. It's not my fault. I'm gonna put it here and get a Twizzler.
Yeah, I really wanted that guy, but I was like, I don't have the two pollen.
Yeah.
Y'all
that was it? A sweet one.
Yeah.
All right.
I really, really needed that, too.
I am going to...
I do like that one, too.
Go and bump whoever Gray is.
It's me!
And I am buying this expensive farm for 3 points.
All right.
That's going to cost me 2 water.
And you gain a worker?
Yes, I get to gain a worker.
You can never have more than 4 workers, right?
Correct.
Right. Okay. So I basically gain it from the hibernation pool. And that would be my turn. Oh, I got to give myself my 3 points. Haha. Don't want to forget that.
All right, Peter.
Untini.
So.
Oh, look who's no longer in the lead.
No.
Oh, no, Peter.
I'm still losing, I would like to point out. So,
Nathan.
No, we had a whole thing about this where John's Nathan. Like, oh, no, I'm losing. Oh, no. And then he ends up winning with 1 billion points.
Nathan, why would you do that to me, man? I had a good thing going. Let's see here. Do we want to do the thing?
With the thing.
Yeah, let's, sure. Why not? Let's go ahead and grow.
All
right. So I've got two strength. So I've got two strength in there. No, I'm going to skip that. I'm going to do the two strength and pay two basic resources to purchase a hive mat.
Yep.
So let's do a Twizzler and a water. All right. And the hive mats are up here. So I just grab one of those. And I come down here. And I can just add it in or like wherever.
Yep, as long as it's touching at least one spot.
Yep.
Cool.
All right, my turn then.
Yep.
All right. Peter, you're getting bumped. Here's your guy. Oh, wait. You're green, right? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I'm green. Mm-hmm.
All right, yeah. I threw your guy over there.
Oh, that was the one that was up there. Okay.
All right. And, yeah, I'm going to spend one water to grab this one here, which is going to then give me one water. And then, yep, and then I gain a Queen's Favor for that, too. All right, that's my turn.
Do I like that one? Oh, it gives me a pollen. So it's not bad.
Yeah, it's not bad.
But I bumped the evil Nathan. Yep, we're bumping the evil Nathan. I put your blue right there.
Okay.
I could pick from any column I want. So I'm going to grab this one.
Yep.
And I pay a water.
I definitely don't resent you for buying that worker.
Oh, it's so good. I get a pollen. But I can't store another pollen, can I?
If you don't have a space to store it, no, you don't.
So I can put that up here. So I'll get a pollen and I take whatever I want. So I get a pollen.
Yeah, you have one spot for pollen.
Go here. Oh, and I'll get a water.
Yeah, that's... Oh, yeah, and I also get a pollen for placing that there because it placed it right by my guy.
Wait, what?
I get a pollen every time I place next to this blue guy here.
Oh, okay. Oh, and someone refilled it for me. Sweet. So that's the end of me. I'm done.
Oh, wow. This one gives you a ship as income.
I know. Shush. I can get it, too, if I have a person, which I don't.
I could get it, too.
I could get it, too. My name is...
Yeah, I'm going to grow. Not research.
That's not grow.
Yeah, I was about to say, that would be research, sir.
Whoever has that green... That's me. I'm green.
Oh, that was actually... That was actually the wicked combo that I got. I got a bunch of stuff that, like, basically every time I get bumped off of research, I get to do, or like, I could go to research and then I could intentionally pull it back from research on my own and then get to do a farm action as a part of that, too. So basically, I just go to research and just farm up, get all the resources I want that way.
So Nathan got himself a hex.
Yep.
Well, why would you do that?
And I'm foregoing the extra little strength. So technically I had one strength left, but I don't have any people to get.
Got it. All right. My turn then?
Yes, it is.
All right. So I will be bumping John.
All right.
And moving, bumping James, and I will go here. So I've got 5+. A water and a fiber. / Twizzler, sorry.
Yeah, we'll keep that.
And I will grab the thing here that gets me my extra extra worker, correct? That's what that one does?
Yep.
Awesome. So I got to figure out where I'm going to put that here on the board. Let's put that one... Let's put that one here, because that will get me a seed as well.
Wax!
So I get my...
That ain't making it to you.
No, it is! It is! Go, go do something else!
Get that, and I get a card.
James, I'll bump your guy for you. See, I'm helping.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and plant this seed.
I really want that waxy one.
Right? That's one of the things that you do with the cards is you play it.
To plant a seed, you have to specifically either like have like this guy here let you do a free plant on something else or play a four down here to plant.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's okay. So you can't play that part of the card.
Yeah, unless
got
you
got it.
Unless
you
do
that action.
Yep.
Yes.
All right, John.
Got it.
You're researching, right?
I'm advancing.
No, you are not.
I am. Here, take your two. And this is going to cost two water and one plant. Oh, look at that. I'm going to take
that.
Nice. Two water, one plant.
You're a monster, dear sir.
And I get a wax as a part of that. The only thing that would have made that better is if I had no place to put that wax.
Well, I hate you to say no.
That's all right.
I'm going to go ahead and put this up here because I sort of want the water one up here anyway, too. So it can be waterific. So green gets four or whatever the heck you want to do with it. I will grab this one.
You could also always put it into your loading if you wanted to specifically recall it for, you know.
Water.
What was it? I can do what with it?
If you don't put it in here,
mm-hmm.
and you put it in your loading area, landing area instead, when you could later recall it from there and then bump it up, you know, normally. But you then get to do, you know, your production with it too.
I'm not sure I understand what all that is. I apologize.
So yeah, whenever you recall your workers,
yes.
every one of your workers can activate one of your farm tiles again. Get the right thing. So when you get bumped like that, instead of putting it in the top area in your active pool, you can put it in your landing area so you can actually recall it to get the income later as an action.
Oh, okay. I gotcha. All right.
But then also getting a four is also nice too. So
exactly. So whose turn is it right now?
Oh, Nathan's.
Okay, oh, gotcha.
My turn? Sorry. That was quick.
Yeah, I just did that thing. I got a queen's favor, a water, and a pollen.
Okay, so
I may have forgot to summon refilled it. Okay.
Yeah. Explore-ish.
Oh, I forgot to get my queen's favor as well.
Ah.
You're just like, chuck them. You're like, ah. Okay. Oh, green gets his other one back.
Peter gets his guy back. I'll put it here for now. And I will go five spaces.
Hey, Peter, your guy's over here. He's getting bumped.
Just for heck of it, I'll go way up here. See what this is. I get a resource of my choice.
Oh, you get a resource. I get dumb things like a point.
Yeah, well, Peter got three resources.
Yeah. Wait until he has to roll dice.
Yeah, seriously.
And then I get to draw.
Fortunately, there's no dice rolling in this game, or I would have been. Oh, you get, and of course you get two more resources. Good for you.
Yes, good for me. So I'm going to take a water and another pollen. So I like pollen. That'd be my turn.
All right, Peter, what do you want to do?
That's a good question. Hmm. Don't have a ton of resources. So that's where I'm down to just a pollen right now. So I need to get some more resources. So probably need to do some exploring. Or I could do the research thing again, right?
Sure.
Yeah.
So if I do the research with my four, that would allow me to plant a seed.
And you would draw four and keep one.
And I would draw four and keep one.
But you can also plant in either order, so you could draw the four first, keep your one.
Okay, you don't have to do it in that order there.
No, not for that one, from what I remember, unless Nathan knows otherwise. Because it's also is four also plant one. So, yeah.
Yeah, you can do it any order. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, you know what? Let's... Yeah, I think that's the one I'm going to do, because I don't have any... Obviously, I don't have any honey yet, so I can't do any of the carve. Can't purchase any of the carve stuff. Well, no, you know what? Forget that. Let's use one of my other numbers. Let's grab this three here, and let's go up to explore. I'm going to bump. That'll be bumping James and bumping Nathan. Nathan will move over. This will go there, so I can move up to six spaces. But let's go ahead.
If you get a four and you put it on grow, does it cost anything to upgrade your faction tile, or that just happens?
It just happens.
Okay. Well, here's... Okay, wait a second.
You can go anywhere on the board you want.
So wait a second. If I had... Instead of using my three to do that, if I used my four and I moved the Bee Queen to Zingy, I would gain two resources plus whatever I put in there, and... I would then be able to teach one dance and use it twice.
Correct.
Yes.
All right. Let's see what happens if we do that. So instead of using the three, I'll use the four.
That was also what I did with my first four. The one time I played this.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So I move this to there. What is this thing here where it says four also gain the negative four benefit?
Yeah, that's basically the printed.
Oh, it's not negative four. It's just printed weird. Okay. All right. Gotcha. All right. So I want to grab, what resource do I want to grab and put in there is the question. I've got a pollen. I guess let's go ahead and put a Twizzler out there. That way I've got one of each thing there. So that's going to gain me a pollen, a water, and a Twizzler. All right. And then the dances, where do I pull the...
Yeah, you just search in there and just grab whichever two.
Yeah, because it's not random. You actually get to choose. Now,
would he be grabbing two of them or just one?
Two.
Depends.
Oh, well, it depends. Unless you're doing this one, where you basically convert one point into another resource of your choice.
Okay. All right. So let's go ahead and search here to see. Is that going to show me? Yeah, it's just taking a second to load. Or it's taking a really long time to load. Probably get his, yeah, there we go. Okay. Interesting. Oh, yeah. Because, and if I make it enticing, you guys will do it more often, which would get me more of the queen's stuff.
Yep.
So let's do that. And let's do fiber and pollen.
All right.
Would get us some honey, because we haven't really had much honey yet in this game.
Yep.
because that's a tough one to get. And I'll put my, yeah, thank you for putting my cube there for me, Nathan. I appreciate that.
You could also put favor there. You could spend favor instead of an actual resource if you wanted.
What is it?
You could also do favor, like, you know, like if you did favor and pollen. That's also an option.
I don't know what you, I apologize. I don't know what you mean by favor.
The Queen's favor. Queen's favor also counts as a resource for convert in that instance.
Oh, it's still in that.
Yeah,
I get what you're saying. So instead of having to spend a resource that is one of those, you can use the Queen's favor as a resource.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I gotcha. That makes more sense because I would have more of that than I would currently of the fiber.
Yeah, yep. And right now you wouldn't be able to do it twice. You don't.
Yeah,
be able
correct.
To do it once.
Exactly. So yeah, thank you for that.
Yeah, I thought I would, you know, point that out since, you know, yeah, kind of like not getting to do it twice is kind of a bummer.
Would kind of be a bummer for sure. Okay. So yeah, so then I would drop my Queen's favor by 2 down to 2.
Yep.
Put you back there and get rid of 2 pollen.
Now, what's the point of honey? Is it wild too, or
so it's purchasing the carves.
Yeah. And the carves are in-game scoring. And that's a lot of points there.
Yeah.
Like
Then hold on a second. Okay, I do have space for storing 2 honeys, right? Yeah.
Oh yeah, you got space for 4. Yeah, these 2 here store just honey and these store honey or wax.
Oh, okay, that's right. I always forget that these down here on the base are got some double spots.
And you could also shift resources around. So it's not like you place a resource there, it's then there, you know.
Right. All right. So I do that twice, which got me the 2 honey.
Yep.
And that is my turn.
All right, John, what you doing?
Oh. Well, I'm gonna do something that's gonna make me very happy. So here, Nathan, you're getting bumped here. That's going to give me 5, and I'm going to buy this here chemist.
No!
Yes! And the fact that you were eyeing it up makes it even better.
I was looking at it the whole time.
I've been too. All right, so I spend 2 pollen for that, and then I get 1 pollen back because I placed them next to my paleontologist. Yes! All right, well, that's my turn. Ooh, what do we get now here? Oh, you get... Basically, you just get to take 2 tokens, because, you know, why not? All of these development tiles are terrible. Really, we need to wipe those out. Like, that one there is the only one that's even kind of anything.
What,
right now.
Which one? The insulation one?
The insulation one is a decent one.
What is
later
it that
on? Basically, it lets you move 3 of your hibernation tokens.
Oh, so the hibernation tokens.
And then you get the bonus of where you move them to. Plus also, you could also be like, okay, I'm losing out the majority bonus in this one. I'm now going to move all 3 of them over here, and now I got majority here locked up. You know,
And again, hibernation is an option when?
When you retire your 4 power worker. Because basically, whenever you recover a 4 power worker, they go into hibernation. And
that's
then you
right.
Pit the token out.
Yeah. And then it becomes a 1 again and it goes over to the side.
Yep.
You have to restore it again.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. The grow or do your your thing that you got there.
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh. Blue 3, by the way, is right here.
Thank you for the bumpage.
James, did you get a better one this time?
No. That's okay. But I get any good I want. And what do I want?
I mean, gain one seed card and gain one hex frame for going to that one. That's interesting.
That's the 4 power on that one?
That's the 4 power there on Malva. Yeah, that's interesting.
Okay.
I don't think I actually ever saw that one.
Okay, that was it for me.
Okay, since James gave me back that 3 that I turned to a 4, I am going to go and carve.
Ooh, there you go.
Which I'm spending my 1 honey to buy this one that's 8 points if it's next to my faction tile.
Oh, okay.
And I get a water for that.
Well, that was a pretty quick turn.
Yep.
What's Peter going to do?
Yeah, that was really quick.
I'm super losing this game.
I don't know about that. I mean, it's kind of hard to say at this point. I mean, sure, somebody's sandbagging like 8 points over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm the carve action has to be 4 only, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Which I currently don't have a 4. Okay.
Yeah, you use the 4 to get the honey that you have.
Exactly, right. Exactly. I got 1 Twizzler, 1 water. 1 Twizzler, 1 water.
Sean might have to recall.
I might actually be forced into it here.
And then if you have to recall, I have to recall.
Yep. Not necessarily. It depends upon what Peter does here. We could have a situation where I have to recall and you don't.
You think?
It's possible.
I don't think he's gonna get the tech towels.
I don't think he has any pollen or wax, so yeah, he ain't doing it, so.
Yeah, I can't do that for sure, even if I want to.
Yeah, so I'm pretty sure we're both there's a chance where you don't have to recall.
Yeah. But I fully expect that I'm recalling.
I get lots of crap recalling, so that's not too bad.
I want to do more cool things. All right. I don't think it's happening, though, on this particular turn. Converting. I can convert. I just can't convert a whole. No, I can't. Never mind. Because I need pollen for converting. No. Because you can do multiple actions, right?
Yeah. Basically, what number you put on there is how many trades you get.
All right. So if I do the... I guess I'm going to go ahead and do the 2 then, I think. Because if I use the 2 to convert, I automatically get a wax because of my hex that I bought earlier.
Yep.
So I can drop that there. I then convert my water into a pollen.
Yep.
And then I convert my pollen and my fiber into another wax.
Okay.
All right, that's me.
John?
All right, I have to recall. Yeah, so
then you get to produce 2 different ones?
Yep.
So you'll get a wax and water?
Yep.
So when you recall those that still acts as bumping, so you still up the number on your worker?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay, got it.
All right. Cool. So yeah, I get a wax that I can't store anywhere right now, and a water, so I'll just get one queen's favor for that.
Yep. All right, so my turn. I'm going to do the same thing. All three are coming back. This one comes here, becomes a four for me. This one goes here, four, or three. Yeah, two, three, and then this one becomes the four. All right, then I get a water and whatever I want, which will apparently be water. And I can't have the pollen, so I get two queen's favors because I got a queen's favor and extra pollen I can't spend. So it's right up here. And that's it for me.
Okay, so I am going to spend my two and be super cheap and get this one I can get for free, which allows me to convert my two exploration things into points.
Yep.
Whoopee. So I get 2 points and I'm getting a bigger lead. Woo! Yay.
All right, new one out here is gain three seed cards.
I also get a card.
Oh.
Do I want to use this right away? I do not. Ooh, don't like that card.
All right, my turn then?
Yep.
All right, so I will bump Nathan on that track that he just went on. And I will go ahead and pay my two wax for that that card that just, or the tile that just came out.
Yep. I was afraid you were going to do that, because that's what I wanted to do.
I was hoping he would flip over a good one, because I've not been overly impressed with them so far, but that one seems kind of fun.
Yep. All right, let's see, we got, what else we got here?
So
trade in this up to three resources to build three farm tiles from the stack.
So where does this need to go?
You're building blindly from the stack.
Yeah. You're just remember it.
It goes there, so I get three seed cards for that.
Was that
Yes.
Alright, so let's get three seed cards. Put those in my hand.
And that's just a one-time thing. So if I get that one there, you can spend up to three resources, build them blindly from the stack, you're done.
Yep.
Yes.
All and you the... also have to have space to put them too, yeah.
Yes, yeah. All the red ones are one time. Peter, do you want to use any of those cards before you end your turn?
That's I'm trying to check real quick to see what they do.
Okay. No rush.
Yeah.
I will be entertaining in the meantime. Yes. Very exciting. I think Peter's doing pretty well so far. Those seed cards are really nice.
Yeah.
I am not unhappy with how I'm doing.
I'm not unhappy with how I'm doing. My name is Nathan.
When it mentions things like if your hive mat is full, that includes then also the hex frames that you add on?
No.
No.
For the 8 points? No.
That's just, so it's talking about just the base, the base board.
Right. The hive mat you added on, if you fill that out, you get another eight points.
Yep.
Well, he's talking about one of the seed cards refers to the hive mat as well. But yeah, that's just the basic section.
Okay. I'm not going to play anything right now, so it's John's turn.
You know what you should do again? Recall.
A total recall.
Exactly.
there's none of these actions that I want to do. They're all terrible.
Well, is there a pass in the game?
I don't think so, but I figured if nothing else, you'd just do a research of, you know.
Research is pretty good.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to do a thing. This will be cool. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to go here.
Oh, you get to teach a dance. No, you're not a four.
That wasn't a four.
But you get the three resources.
I get the three resources, which is really what I was after.
All right, well, that's
I'm not done yet.
What are you doing?
I ain't done yet. Now I'm going to play my seed card, which lets me play a second worker.
Why don't you play a second worker?
And here you go, PETA. And this
you paid your resource to do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
I haven't paid it yet, but I am paying it, yes.
So then you're going to bump Peter.
I'm going to bump Peter, which kind of breaks
his guy.
Yeah, which actually breaks. We have to resolve his hibernation first before I continue the rest of my turn.
Yep. So
what resource
we'll
am I spending?
Walk you through that. He hibernates. He becomes a one. He goes over here.
Yep.
And Peter gets to put one of his hibernation tokens on one of these bonuses and get the bonus.
Right. So let's take a quick look at these bonuses. So we've got like this one down here that says wax. And then what's this after the wax?
You can wipe the red.
Okay. That's wipe. That's wiping those tiles.
Yep.
Okay. Gotcha. So we got just Queen's Favor. We got multiple ones here with wax, multiple ones with honey.
Actually, that's the only one with honey.
Yeah.
That's some that are just points.
Yep.
Seed card can be pretty good. Honey is obviously pretty good.
Wiping out a specific market can be good if, you know.
Yeah, but it could also just really just benefit you guys right away.
It could, yeah.
So,
I'm fine with this.
I've got the room for it, so I'm going to go ahead and grab another honey.
I was going to say, you might also want to pay attention to which one you want to try for control over.
Exactly, yep.
Yep.
So, I'm going to go ahead and grab another honey and drop that over here onto my board.
All right.
So now I go back here. Yeah, that's right. I wanted to get the free expansion board and seed card.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you get to put a resource there and you get those two, right?
Yep. And I'm going to put plant fiber there. So then I get a pollen and a fiber.
All right. And you just got to put your board somewhere.
Yep. And that's just going to go right. Yeah.
All right. My turn's easy. I'm knocking Nathan off, I think. There.
Okay.
But I'm putting a four there. So I get a bunch of stuff. The first thing I do is I upgrade my faction board for free.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to take all my resources off for right now. So.
And your board's currently locked, so you're going to have to unlock it.
Well, the only one I trust to take care of my board is John. So
that's
all right.
I already unlocked it for you.
I almost might have wanted to play my card.
Someone unlocked the wrong board. I need this thing unlocked, right?
Yeah. Wait. What were you trying to do? Flip your. Oh, were you doing grow? Yeah. You don't have to actually flip.
You don't have
board.
To flip it. You change said, the state.
Change the state.
Yeah. So this needs to go back.
And just change state to 2.
Yes, it finally happened. James is having an awful time playing TTS.
Yep.
Here, I'll...
I got it.
You want me to do it for you?
I need people to not touch my stuff.
There you go. Your state's 2 now. There you go. You're upgraded.
No, it's not even better.
It's a little better, right?
Well, as soon as you upgrade, you get to get a free tile.
Yeah, you get a free tile. Worker or basically a blue or green tile, your choice.
It comes from the stack, so blind.
Yep.
What? Yeah, so if I upgrade on upgrade.
Yeah, you get a blue or a green tile of your choice, blind from the top of the stack.
What is upgrade?
That's
you just upgraded.
You just upgraded. When you went put the four on here, that's you upgraded your faction tile. So it's basically, you know.
So then I get this or next time I upgrade?
Get it right now.
You get it right
now.
It's
the only time you can upgrade.
So I can build one for free from the stack.
Yep.
Yes.
So I'll take the blue one for free.
Get something good.
Wait, who flipped my other thing?
I don't know who flipped that.
Wasn't me. I wasn't anywhere near it.
Oh, wow. That is nice.
Yes.
I didn't see, never seen that one before.
And I don't get that immediately, right? Or I do?
Yeah, you do. Yeah. So now if you, whenever you do research, if you draw at least two, you get to keep both of them.
Oh, cool. I don't know where I'm going to set that real quick. I'm going to finish my other stuff real quick. So I'm going to get rid of pollen to get my other worker. I'm then going to get rid of two waters to get an extension board. Then I'm going to start filling the stuff on the board here to see where I have room to put things. Water. Whistler. Ah, dang it. I need to have more storage. So he's going to go here, which gives me nothing. And I just go up the train's Queen's track once.
Oh, because you don't have room for it. Yes.
And I get my expansion board here.
That's because somebody keeps on buying the green tiles he was wanting that had that kind of storage.
Yeah, it was. And I'll just set that here. Set that here. All right.
One thing that could be a little confusing in this game is your drones are black. Your hibernation tokens are this white one. It's like they almost look the same, but they're...
Yeah.
So here's a question. If I go to the grow spot and it says upgrade my faction again, do I get that upgrade ability? No, just one time.
Yep.
All right.
Okay. So I am going to go and bump Peter at the convert place. So Peter gets that. Right. And I am just going to get a honey for basically a bunch of resources. And that is my turn.
Man, I'm actually super jelly about that work, that recruit that you got, James.
Oh, real? Oh, yeah, that I got on there?
That's super the keep cool. a second one? Yeah, that's so good.
Guess what I'm going to be doing?
It's now Peter's turn.
Converting?
It is my turn, yes, that is true.
Well, that one's on research, so I have to go to research to keep the second.
Yeah, you have to actually do the research action to be able to keep two, yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do that first.
It's Peter's turn, right?
Yeah, I'm just thinking my way through it right now.
You're good.
I think, though, that I'm just going to go... I think I'm going to go up here and bump Nathan, which will then bump me to there. Wait a second. No. I apologize. That makes no sense. Nathan, come back. I apologize.
Come back, Nathan. Come back. Look at how sad Nathan is. Look at his face.
I know. He's so sad now. He's so sad now. He's so sad now. That's my bad. I was not paying attention to the fact that I did not have the pollen to purchase these.
Ah, yeah, no problem.
So I probably am gonna need to do.
You can need a level 4.
I need to wipe this row out. That's what I need to do.
Which row?
The planting row.
The plant row? Yeah, maybe.
Conversions aren't going to do me any good. I think I have to go exploring pretty much is where I'm at with myself. I think I have to
explore. You're helping out the Red Menace.
I know it's not what I want to do.
How is he helping out the Red Menace? How is exploring going to help me?
Well, you're going to bump a guy up to 4, probably, I would assume. But
yeah, he's going
to
bump you.
Where are you placed?
Oh, he bumped my... Oh, yeah.
As if it is.
I mean...
I'm not actually probably not going to bump him up to a 4 immediately. Oh, that is one other thing, too. If you happen to have no drone ships, which is possible, I'm actually on the cusp of being in that situation, you get a free one. Okay. So you get if they're all hibernating, you get one for free.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
All right. So let's go ahead then, and I'm going to put this guy out. I'm going to bump John. John, you're going to bump one of those guys over. Moves. This guy goes here.
So when he goes down that bottom part, do you just produce?
Whenever I do a recall, he then will get a chance to produce, yeah.
And then he goes up a level or no?
And then he goes up a level, yep. And basically, it's like proxy staying on the board. It's like, I didn't actually want him to come back yet.
Okay. Do I want to do a new one, or do I want to go somewhere we've already been before?
I don't know. Depends on what you need.
Yep. I know, right?
You want to play with Lady Luck, or do you want to get
like good stuff? Guaranteed good stuff. Let's go ahead and go here. Let's go ahead and go there and drop a pollen on it. Now just give me one of each thing.
All right, did you want to play any of your cards?
Don't. Don't think so. No, I'm good.
All right,
John.
My turn then, huh? All right. Well, I'm going to start by playing a card. Everyone's going to love me.
Nope.
No. I draw 4 farm tiles from the top. I take one and pass it to the left.
Oh, I do love you because I'm next
like
to
it,
you.
I'd like so it I better. I was going to say, I'd like it better if you pass it to the right.
And Peter gets screwed.
I'd get the drug. I get the
gets,
dregs.
Yeah,
he gets whatever
nobody
left.
Else wants.
I enjoy
get
this.
One. It's not the worst. You get one.
And when when you place that, you do get the immediate thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm pretty certain, yeah. Yep.
All right, so which one are you picking, John?
Ooh.
Actually, you might as well put them all out so we can all see them.
Oh,
all
yeah. So that way, yeah.
There you go.
So we can think about it.
That way I can be really disappointed after I see the ones I want and they're not there.
Yeah. Yes, exactly. Like 100% what's going to happen in this situation.
It's exactly what's going to happen.
Oh, man. I'm torn. Getting extra.
I know which one I need to get, even though it doesn't help me very well.
So I don't think I'm getting that one or that one. I'm down to these two, and one of them I know is the one that James was talking about.
I know, but do you need it? No, you don't
need
it.
Yeah, I do, because I need ships. I'm about ready to lose all my ships.
Can always grow.
Why would I do that? That's basic.
You're so basic.
Scrubs grow.
Your face grows.
No, it doesn't. Well, it does, but it's currently shaved.
Your ears will continue to grow for the rest of your life. They become these dangly things when you get older and older. Eventually, just like it starts slapping you when you walk around corners.
Do I take the free ship?
I mean, I'm fine with the Twizzler and
I know that's kind of like that's also I want also getting the fiber and the Queen's Favor is also really nice.
Yep,
and that's the one I'm going for.
Yeah,
I know. Well, I'm taking
this one even though I don't get the ship right now.
Well, obviously I'm taking the 2 points.
Ooh, I don't get a pawn either. What am I doing? Oh, I do get a pawn because that's what I put it on.
And a favor.
All right, I'll take.
And you get that dang thing.
I'll take one victory point.
All right, now John gets to take his turn now.
And I also gain a seed card.
Oh, why?
Because I covered a seed card spot. Oh,
yeah, yeah, you're good. You're good. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, do I want to play this one?
I got one more thing to clean my cover my area.
Not right now. Interesting.
Oh,
now we're good. All right, so now we're going to do my action here. All right.
Which is
a tough call. Yeah, we're going to do it. All right. Dropping to 4 right here. So Nathan's getting bumped off and Peter's getting bumped down.
What are you getting?
And I'm it's a tough call. I can get whatever I want here.
But
I don't really want the navigator.
That Peter failed to fulfill.
I'm going to take the hybridization.
Ah.
So, spend my 2 wax.
Oh, and you get 2 cards off the top of the green stack.
No, I get
pretty good.
I get to spend 3. I have 3 resources that I could spend for that. So, I get 3 off the top.
Oh,
of
you're
there.
Doing 3. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I'm doing the full 3, baby.
And you're not going to have anything left. And then I'm going to call you John Too Few Resources. That's going to be your name.
I still got plenty of resources. What are you talking about? I still got plenty of
John Too Few Resources. Pollen. What are you talking about?
I got 2 pollen. In fact, I'm going to put my pollen together because that's how they roll up there.
Pollinating everywhere.
Yep. All right. So, yeah, I spent my 3 resources. I'm going to drop it there. That's going to get me a point. Yay! I got a point, everyone.
Way to go, John.
I'm still
in last.
We
knew you could do it.
All right. And then I get 3. Oh, one hit. Ooh. Queen's Chamber. Ooh, the Queen's Chamber. Ooh la la.
We'll get it.
Ooh. Yeah, not bad.
All right, so I get 3 off the top here. Not bad. Not bad. I can live with this. All right. We'll put that one there. And in fact, let me just go and get on my resources. I get 2 Queen's Favor, a pollen, and a water.
Oh my!
Yeah, I'm comboing here pretty hard. Let's see here.
I have a quick question for anybody who the victory points that are on the tiles that we put on our mat. That's at the end of the game, right?
Yep.
Yep. Because you can potentially lose the tiles.
Oh, okay. That's good to know. I don't think I knew that.
Yeah, there's some cards that let you like discard a tile or something like that. Or I think there's some of these that might let you discard a tile too.
Other people's or your own?
Your own.
I don't think you can do other people's. I'm pretty sure there's no way to do that.
I don't think there's any way to do that. Yeah.
Gotcha. That would be super mean. So.
Well, if there was, I would do it to John because he's too many tile John. That's his new name. Too many tile, John.
Yeah, what did you do just now that got you all those? What did you do?
I did I played a card that gave me a free green one. Then I did this one here, which let me spend 3 resources to build 3 from the stack.
Oh wow!
Yep. And then I just placed this one, which now lets me grab another lightning tile for free.
Well, no, is that to build three from the stack for free?
You're spending three resources to build. You don't have to pay the cost of those.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
But you're blindly building.
Yeah. I don't know what I'm building. Yeah.
Interesting.
And I get the Queen's Chamber, which is four more favor.
I know what you're building. My butt.
Yeah, his favor is just really, really.
So you all done now? Can I actually take my turn now, John?
No.
How many cards can you play a turn? Any as many as you want?
Yep.
Yeah. I could build one more thing, but
how would you build one more thing?
Because I have a card.
Because he has more cards.
I love it. Do it and let me take my turn.
I love it.
Have a good turn.
But
it's
no,
not as good
I need to you know I all right, I
shut your
things.
Face, I'm taking my turn.
All right, I'm done.
All right, so I draw four cards. I only have to discard two. And I get to plant one for free. Okay. Okay. So I'm going to discard this one. And I'm going to discard that one because I'm not doing that either. And I will... I will go ahead and put that bugger there. Yeah, it's planted.
There you go. Planted.
And then I'm good.
There's a lot of things I want to do, but what I think I'm going to do is bump myself.
You just bump yourself.
So then you hibernate.
That hibernates.
Yeah. So you have to do that first.
Where's my hibernation tokens?
They should be on your... Yeah, there you go.
I'm going to go over here to get the seed card.
Yep.
See if I get anything great. Interesting. Not great. Then I am buying this one for one honey, which is going here to get me my hibernated guy back.
Okay.
And that would be my turn.
All right. So again, first time playing through a game, I can play as many cards as I want on a turn, and cards can be discarded to turn them into resources.
Yep. One of the three basics. Yep.
Yep. That's one of the things I keep forgetting about, but that is okay. So I'm going to... Which one of these am I going to get rid of in order to... I think I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this card to gain a resource. I'm going to gain a pollen. I am then going to... Is that going to work? Yeah, that's still going to work. That's still going to work. Okay. I'm going to play this here up at the recruit, which is going to bump me and bump John. I will then with my two pollen, I will purchase this navigator token.
Okay.
So two pollen, navigator token.
Just glad you didn't take the one I wanted.
Navigator token
It's okay, I will.
Navigator token will go there, which also gets me another basic resource.
Oh, wow.
I'll grab another pollen. And then I will play another card, which is the, I'm playing this one for its action, which is pay a resource to place a second worker.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
So I will go ahead and pay, I'm gonna pay the water, I guess. I will place my four worker over on Carve Bumping Nathan.
So then we have to pause. So
because he's gonna hibernate. Yep.
Yep. So first of all, that becomes a one and goes over here, and then I can hibernate, which I'm gonna take another of these cool seed cards. Okay.
All right. And then for my carve action, I will be paying 3 honey for the cluster tile.
Okay.
Which I will place there, which will get me one up on the Queen's Favor track. Which is here. Bumps me to there. And that's my turn.
Okay. So, John.
All right. Well, mine's going to be boring. I am recalling, but I get to do 2 hibernations as part of that recall.
So, here's a question. When you recall and they become hibernated, do you still do the produce?
Yes.
Okay. So you can produce up to 3 times right now, 3 different tiles.
Yep. Let's see.
But you have to do your hibernation thing first.
Yep. All right, so 2 hibernations. Let's see. I'm going to go here, get 2 points, and wipe out the recruits. Once per turn, you just basically you can do. That's cool. That's cool. And that's cool. That's all good ones out there. Interesting. All right. And then, yeah, I don't like any of those either. So you want, I'm the master resetter.
Okay.
All right. And so yeah, now I get to do my 3 production.
So the end game gets triggered when the hibernation comb is full, right?
Either yeah. When it's full or one person has used all 7 of their hibernations.
Okay.
Yep. All right.
Now I gotta produce.
So I'm going to get a favor and a plant. And then do I want 2 favor or water? Let's take 2 favor. Yeah, unless is the water going to be more important for me in the short term. Kind of. Wax is also not bad, I guess. Yeah, actually, instead of that, I am going to take 1 wax.
Okay.
All right.
All right, so I'm going to play this card. And I know it sounds weird, but I'm going to put my three over here, which counts as a four.
Yep.
So the first thing I need to do is hibernate.
Yep.
Then I shall place this one on this space. So I gain a wax, which I will put down here. Just because. So I hibernated. My three goes here. This counts as a four. So I'm going to draw four cards, and then I can plant one and keep two.
Yep.
So let's see.
Shoot, guys, I got another quick question. Sorry.
Now you go ask a question.
John, yep. Would you look at this cluster hex that I just dropped in a second ago?
Yep.
The victory points are at the top, not at the side of the hex.
Correct.
Does that mean that happens when I place it?
No, this is in-game scoring. So right now,
because it threw me, because this one over here has a victory point at the top.
That's because that's part of the income. So as income for that one, you can just take a point.
So income is only for the farm tiles?
Yes.
Okay.
And gotcha. That's only whenever you are doing the recall action.
That's what I thought. It kept throwing me off that they were all on top, but it's only the ones that have that little recall symbol there.
Yep.
And thank you. Points on this one. On the cluster is referencing the text, though, so you gain 3 points per
yep. basic tile. So right now, it is worth 15 points for you.
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
Right, so I planted my card. I'm going to play this card, though. It says, pay one to move the queen ship one space and explore the location. And I am going to use Lady Luck, because I'm just going to go over here and see what happens, which gives me two C cards.
Oh, there you go. Come on.
There you go.
Come on.
Nice. Which is awesome. And then I get a place here. Yeah, thank you.
My name's James, and I'm totally going to lose.
So I get that'll give me two resources. What do I want out of this? I think I want to do a water and pollen. So I will put a water here. So I will gain a water and pollen. And where'd the queen ship go? Where'd I put that? Oh, it's right. Where'd it go? Oh, yeah, over there. So it goes on that. And I got two cards. Do I want to do anything with these cards?
You know, it also looks like
I'm playing this card so I can recollect one of them, so then doesn't I can do the two seed ones.
Yep.
So I'm gonna get two more seed cards. This is amazing.
Yeah, see, I told you like the seed cards can be pretty strong.
What? So here, if I did that, I could reactivate a four bonus on any face-up planet?
Yes.
Yep.
So I don't have to be on that planet?
Nope.
So I'm going to do that, because I'm going to spend two water to do that. And I'm going to do the one where I get to teach a dance and play it twice.
So you pick one of the two remaining dances. Get the tokens to fill it up. I'll put your claim token on the place for you.
I will say I've been a little sad that nobody else has done the minus queen favor in pollen, so I can get some queen favor.
You will at some point. I can guarantee you will definitely get a bunch of queen's favor from me.
All right, because I was like, it has not happened at all since I put it out there.
It's because there's been too many other things I've had to do to be able to get to where I could actually
start spending it.
Yes.
Got it.
Well, I still have zero queen's favors.
Well, that's true. Yeah.
I can't do that.
I have some to spend. And
yeah, you do.
And also, the thing is, though, and I have it, and I haven't used them yet. Anytime I do something for honey,
yeah,
I spend one less pollen. So all I have to do is your dance, and I just have to spend one favor to get a honey.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Which one of your tiles was that one?
It's this guy right here, I think.
convert wax and honey.
Yeah, whenever I convert for wax and honey, costs one poly.
All right, nice. So I get to do this twice. Yeah. I'm going to lose two favor.
That's what I'm saying. You're going to get a bunch off of me.
I'm going to lose two victory points, but I gain four victory points, so that just puts me up two victory points. And I get two more seed cards.
Nice. All the seed cards. James is taking the whole stack.
I'm trying. I'm going to see what I do with these now.
Which cards out here should actually be in the discard pile?
I assume all of these here.
James just keeps laying them down.
I keep getting them. But don't move my planted ones. Those are planted.
No, those are planted.
I think we should discard those too.
I will destroy you.
Okay.
Well, no, hold on.
No, James is just doing all the things right now.
Yep.
He's trying to make up for the rest of the game so far.
All right, I'm going to teach the other dance too.
You can't teach more than one, actually.
Yeah, teach one dance if you haven't taught a dance.
Oh, okay. All right.
That's why you only have one little cue claimed to you.
Oh, you can only ever teach one dance.
Okay. Yeah, correct.
Okay. I'm good for now.
Okay.
That was an amazing turn.
That was a big turn.
I'm going to do a half a James turn.
A half a James turn, okay.
So I'm going to start by giving myself 5 points by running both my point scoring ones.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Then I am going to change my 3 to a 4.
Okay.
And then I am going to take that 4 and go up here and knock.
Which gives you 3 points.
Yes, that gives me 3 more points. I'm kind of going on the point scoring strategy.
Wow, I couldn't tell.
And I get this...
Apparently, points win the game.
I forgot to get my 3 points for placing my 4 in advance.
Well, then go do it.
That's important.
What
I
is
can
it?
No longer claim to be in last place.
So if you put a 4 on advance, you get 3 points.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
got it.
It's the weakest of the 4 things.
It's the weakest of the 4 things, but yeah, it's there.
I had like too many other things going on. That was like that entire long term where I did a lot of other stuff. Like, yeah.
What tile did you end up getting, Nathan?
I took the tile that let me put down a hibernation token, and I got a wax for my hibernation.
Oh, yeah, and the hibernation token goes over here, right?
Yep.
And which?
Yeah,
and
I took the wax.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay.
What happens if there's a tie in the hibernation cone thingy do?
I would have to look that up.
I think it's
if it's a tie for first place, you add the 7 and the 2 or the 9 and the 4 together, and then you split it rounded down.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't think there can be a tie with our player count. Well, there can be on the other one.
Yeah, the other one definitely is going to probably have a tie at this point.
Okay.
Yeah. So this one here could even have a tie as well if like two people put 2 in.
Well, that's true. It could.
Yeah, sure.
Nathan, are you done on your turn?
Yes.
Okay.
I mean, if I am done that, I was definitely going to do that, but now
I'm going to recall.
And then so you get to produce.
So it's the first time I've ever done this. So I'll describe this one first. When I recall, they do change numbers, correct?
Yep. Yes.
All right, so goes to number 2. I will use this one to produce the 3 in the queen's favor. So that's going to take me from 3. Oh, shoot. Should take me 3 to 6. James goes back to the 3.
Is there any card limit count?
In your hand? I don't think so. All right, so I did the 1. And then this one comes down. And it becomes a 4. And it goes there. And I will use that to, do this recruiting.
Yep.
Okay.
So grab my 4th guy there. Thank you. And then my last guy is a 4 already, so he has to hibernate.
Yes.
But he still does his... he does his farming action, correct?
No, actually.
Oh, no?
Yeah, when they're hibernated, they don't farm.
They don't farm. Okay.
Oh, right. Is that true?
Because yeah, I think because John
yeah,
definitely
I think
did
I,
earlier.
I, yeah. So I need to get two less things then, so we'll just lose the water and two favor then.
Okay. All right. So then I hibernate, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to grab a wax and reset all of the other junk.
The red ones, right?
Yeah, the red ones are going to get reset. So they're going to go here, here, and here.
I might have to actually pick up this game.
Yeah, I like it.
Oh, no, not that. There. All right, so that resets all of those. Let's see here. Don't want to do that. And I can't do that.
I like to explore any location as a strength 4. That's pretty good.
Yeah. What about this one here? So this is obviously the explorer token. Do I take that from the board?
Or do you take it from this thing here? No, what's this thing up here doing?
Yeah, I take it from the stack. All right, because when I hover over it, it was saying, what did it say here? Gain any explorer token from the board and receive its benefit. Place a face-up planet onto the space which... Oh, no, it does say to do that. Okay, I apologize. I forgot that if you hover over it, it tells you, it kind of gives a further explanation in the scripting. All right, so I just need to choose a random one of these, and hopefully it gives me something good. Let's go for this one way up here.
Two sticks!
Two Twizzlers. So that goes down here.
And does an explore planet plop out?
Yeah, according to the text on this card, yeah. Place a face-up planet.
Yep, so we put a face-up planet out there. Okay, you already got one out there. So that's going to get me another...
Do you get that? Because does that count?
Oh, I know. You know what? I don't know that I do. Because I didn't actually put the queen there.
Do not
yet. No, you don't.
Yeah, do not explore it. Yeah, do not explore it. So it's just there. Shoot.
Can I put that in the discard pile?
Yes, please do. Thank you. So I don't have a place to put that other Twizzler. I'm out of places to store. So I'm going to lose it, but that's going to gain me a favor, right? If I just lose it?
Yeah.
Yes.
That's not bad. So I'll go ahead and do that. I'll do that, and that's going to get me one favor. Yeah, and I'm going to say that that is my turn.
Yeah, what you doing, John?
All right, I don't have a whole lot of choices.
You have one person left?
I have one person left, and it's a 4. So here, I'm bumping you off over here. I figure I might as well go ahead and get myself some people.
So I immediately have to do the hibernation thing.
Yep.
And I will go here to get a card.
Nice. So James and I are going to share that one.
Yep.
Yes. And sharing is caring.
Sharing is caring.
Okay.
All right. And then I'm going to spend 2 to get 2 workers. And then spend.
Oh, and you get to upgrade your thingy do.
Yep, which I did.
Okay.
Upgrade what thingy do?
Home hive or whatever it's called.
Yep. So yeah, now I get for this one I get 3 points per adjacent farm to it.
Yeah. What the hell? I only get 1 point per tile.
Yeah, but that's just 1 point per tile in your entire tableau.
Yeah, well, you know, your sound better.
Your sound better.
All right, and then I'm then also going to build one of these.
Actually,
and
yours can be better.
It can be.
Mr. Green Farmer.
Well, no, because if you get more than 12 tiles, then yours is better. Because I'm at max. Mine's at maximum now. I can't get any more points off of
mine. It has to be adjacent to your... Okay, yes. Okay. I see what you're saying. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm maxed out on mine. So, yep. no, I want to put that there like that. There we go. That's what I want.
All right. Are you all done?
Yeah, I did that. So, yeah, I'm done.
I'm bumping my own little guy to put that there. He becomes a 4 for me. And I get to draw 2 cards. And do I want to play anything?
I'm going to throw that over there.
All right, I'll just go up 3 on this track. So I'll get rid of this one. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, wow.
So that gets discarded. I will. That's super expensive. Stress this stuff doesn't matter quite yet. Go ahead, Nathan.
Okay. I am gonna do.
Oh, wait.
Go, Nathan. No, wait. Don't go, Nathan.
What did I get confused? Hold on.
Yes, you probably happened here. You should do that.
I get to draw 4 cards and get one. Oh, I hibernated, but then I didn't do my action. Okay, so I got to draw 4 cards.
Well, oh yeah, you did. You get the one that gives you.
I got the one that gave me a card, and then I got confused.
Well, you don't get to draw 4 cards. You placed a 1. You draw 1 card.
A 1 card and keep 2. Okay.
Yeah, and since you only draw 1.
I've only been placing 4s there, so.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see if that's any good. I hate helping people, so nah. I'm good. All right. Thank you. I messed myself up.
Okay. I am going to go. I have several ways of doing the exact same thing, so I'm going to do it this way. Oops. So, and I'm spending 1 wax.
Okay.
To buy this one, because I get a 1 wax discount. Placing it up here. And I immediately get to explore a location as if it was a strength 4. So I'm going to do this one to get myself a pollen, a water, and a Twizzler.
Yes, Twizzler! That's what we're talking about. James, I feel like we won the game already now.
Yeah, I don't care if I win. Everyone's calling him Twizzlers.
We'll get
John.
No, John hasn't yet, yeah.
And I won't.
He won't now that you said it. It's going to make you
feel I wasn't already. I was like, nope, I'm not playing this game.
At the convention, I'm going to have a bag of Twizzlers. I'm going to be, John, do you want a Twizzler? Be, yes. John, do you want to have a Twizzler? Yes.
No.
The whole time.
I hate Twizzlers.
John, do you want licorice?
John,
do you
want licorice? Oh, I hate, no, no.
John, do you want black licorice?
It tastes like vomit. No, thank you.
No, I like black licorice. I do not like regular Twizzlers.
You want salt taffy?
Nope.
So I'm doing this dance and running it twice, so I'm changing 2 points for 2 honey.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
That is my turn.
That was your turn?
Yes.
Okay. Interesting. Nathan, you did something interesting.
I tend to do that.
You do. You do. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna bump Nathan off this convert.
Okay.
And put a two there. So you hibernate, right? You had a four there?
No, I had a two there. A one there, actually.
Oh, that was just a one? Oh, for some reason, I thought you had a four there. Me not paying attention. All right, so put a two there. That's gonna let me take two actions here on the conversion. I'm gonna do the one that Nathan just placed. I'm gonna take one negative point to gain a honey.
Oh, you're in last place, Peter.
I know, I went from first to last. It was bound to happen eventually. And then I will exchange a favor on the queen's board and a pollen to gain a second honey.
Oh wait, you can do the dances too anytime?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's just basically you're adding those as extra
conversion options. Yep. So I did those two conversions. No one did
the card one. The card one's awesome.
You. Yeah, I think that's it for me on this one.
Okay. John?
All right. I just got a bunch of weak guys out here, so I'm just going to do this, and I'm going to move one and just get one of each resource. Sweet. All right, that's it for me.
All right, I'm going to bump my two with this four, or my one with this four that becomes a two. And now I draw four cards and keep two, and I can plant one. How does that work? If I draw four cards and I have to return two, could they be any two from my hand?
Pretty sure it has to be from the ones you just drew.
That would be what I would think.
That one's stupid, so that's gone away.
I don't like that one.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
It's not good. Ooh, that one's not bad. I'll keep that one. And that one's also good. And now I'm going to do things with these cards. But first, I get to plant a card. Which will be this one. And then I will let's see which one I'm gonna do.
Hey Nathan.
Yes.
I'm looking at your education.
I will do this
hex.
One.
Uh-huh.
So it's blank in the middle there. What's that mean?
So what it is a
so I have to refresh this first.
Adjacent, instant cards again. So it's worth 5 points right now.
Oh, I gotcha. That's pretty cool.
Oh my gosh, collect all your production one time.
What's going on? Which one?
This one here. Collect all your production one time.
You jerk face, you wiped that?
Yes.
He did wipe
really
it.
I really wanted something out of that.
So I'm going to go ahead and I'll place this one here, which gets me another card. Well, I want that place right. And then I get to do all my product. Oh my gosh.
It's because you have this one here. Let me help you here.
Yeah, you do all that stuff. I'll get all my junk. I get a worker back.
That is actually behaving weird there.
That'll give me one favor and a water. Isn't that being really weird?
Yeah, it is.
That's going to give me another queen's favor because I can't collect it. Then this can give me any resource that I want.
Yeah, that one's just broken. It
with
is
the water.
It does not want to put it in the correct location, no matter what I do here. Here, let's grab another tile, see if maybe... See if maybe it's just that one. No. I've been grabbing all the ones from here. Let's see if maybe these ones are okay. Yeah, that one works.
Okay, whatever.
So basically, the ones in the left-hand side here are broken. Always pull from the right.
I could do this one here that refreshes that one, and then I get one for negative one Twizzler and water.
Oh, here, which way did you want this? Did you want it here or did you want it?
I want it up here.
All right.
Yeah, like that. Yeah, I will... Crap. Eh. I need more Ponta. I'll throw this here. That'll give me two waters. And it's free.
James, are you still going?
Yep, I'm going My to go gosh. Ahead and convert three waters to honey pot. No, come back.
Here, we'll lock down that tile so you don't do that anymore.
And I get a honey pot. Put this here for funsies. Yeah, I got all my bees back too. Oh, when I got this tile. Oh, I got the water tile instead. Okay, so that's why I don't have my other one back.
Did we skip me or something?
Nope.
My turn. No, James has been going for ages.
Forever. All right, I'm good. Go ahead. I don't need to do any of these right now.
I feel like I was actually skipped.
No, you were not skipped.
I feel like it.
You might, because it was forever. Now it's Nathan's turn. Those cards are insane.
John, on your last turn, I'm pretty sure you went up and you did the explore action.
You did.
Yep, that was my last
action. And then James has been here forever.
Ever. Well, I get all these cards. I could chain them. I'm like, this is awesome.
Chat seems to agree with me that James is a cheater and a cad, so...
So, what?
It's Nathan's
turn. You're bumping yourself and making yourself hibernate?
Yes, I am going to make myself hibernate.
Okay.
Which,
Go up and get some Queen's Favor?
I will get my first Queen's Favor, but more importantly, that gives me the majority there.
Yeah.
Currently.
Yeah, we'll see how long that lasts.
Yeah.
Well, very least I will tie.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And some nice person can take that spot.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
John can do it. Why would they help the person who's currently in the lead?
Yeah.
Well, just in points.
Yeah, is the only metric matters. For determining winning.
The only thing that determines the winner. Points.
Well, I am taking this.
Got two endgame tiles, which I have none.
I'm retrieving these two guys. And because of that, which allows me to score 5 points. So I'm at the 21. Okay.
Okay. Is that it, Nathan?
Yes.
Okay.
If I put it over here, I get to get my this guy back. Okay, yeah, now I'm done.
Okay, all right. I will take...
What does it mean when you place your token from your supply onto a planet?
Place a token.
Oh, I have no idea.
One of your resources?
Nope. It says take two tokens from your supply onto any planet. So that's just resources?
Yeah, you take two of your resources, and I believe that one allows you to like take the ones that are there or something like that.
Yeah.
All right, so I am placing my four over here on Carve and paying two honey.
Uh-huh. Don't take the one I want.
Oh, I'm going to try to, but I don't know. There's nothing underneath that. Yeah, so I'm just placing that there, which now has that and that adjacent. Yes, okay, perfect. It's gonna be a pretty straight up basic turn. I don't think, just double checking, but I don't think I'm doing anything else on this turn. Nope, I am good to go.
All right, I John, also you're doing a basic turn. Spending a water and a plant. And grabbing this tile here.
All right, my turn.
Yep.
All right, everybody, we can go to bed now. We'll wake up and James will be done with his turn.
Yeah, I'm going to hibernate him.
And I get a card. Well, I could be done. I forgot about this.
Oh, wait, are you still doing stuff?
Yeah. Have you done anything yet?
Not really.
Nothing that matters. Just go ahead.
All right. I am going to do this one because everybody loves me.
James, where was that guy at?
All right. I draw four cards and I draft them.
Okay.
So this one here, I think I do need to actually keep hitting because, you know, you guys shouldn't know what everybody else got here.
Gotcha. But
let me go ahead and okay, interesting.
James, this one was a four.
It's the four's already there for a one now, but yes. As soon as he's done, I have to hibernate and then take my turn.
Gotcha, okay. Of course, he's going to make you make a decision first because you're going to have to choose between the three leftover cards.
Yeah.
Yep, and then you get the unfortunate one.
Again.
All right, don't care about.
Don't you get the same thing happen to you in Lords of Waterdeep?
All right, that's
a lie. Yes.
All right, how do you peek?
Hold Alt and Shift when your mouse is over it.
Ooh,
this is James's first time using Tabletop Simulator.
Pretty close.
First time, and he's only been playing it for 3-4 years now.
What does it mean when it adds it to your reserve and only you may build it?
It basically means that, it's in your reserve and only you may build it.
What does that even, how do I build it then?
I think you just
pay its resource, pay the cost.
Whenever you can pay its resources and build it.
Just at any point in time you finally have the ability to pay the cost of it, I would assume.
Yep.
On your turn.
Look up the specific card if you want me.
No, I think that sounds about right. So that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah, it's card number 34.
Card number 34.
That's interesting. I didn't realize that all the cards had numbers on them.
Yeah.
What? That doesn't make sense.
Oh, wait. Oh, no. Yeah.
Sense.
Oh,
it's
he
card
grabbed
number
it.
30. It's card 30.
Yeah, sorry. Okay, he grabbed it. I just looked, quick look. I was like, oh, yeah, that's 34.
You may later build a tile by taking the appropriate advance action with any strength worker. So you still have to take an advance
action. Oh, still have to take the action. Okay.
But nobody else can build it.
Doesn't make any sense.
It's just
here,
basically.
I'm
going to
put that
can
one back. I don't want that one. I'm going to take this other one, and you guys can add your cool stuff. Because I'm going to have an awesome turn. And you're going to be sad.
Oh, I already am.
You're like, it's going to be an awesome turn. You don't get any points for resources, right?
James, you know that awesome, no. that long doesn't equate to awesome, right?
No, it does. It does. Choo-choo. Here we go.
Buckle up, everybody.
Everybody on the awesome train.
Buckle up, Buttercup.
Peter gets the last one.
I probably got the one that James said he didn't want.
Yeah, probably.
All right, which is this card right here?
Yep.
All right.
Okay. John, are you done then?
Yeah, I'm done.
All right, so I'm going to put this on here for the multi one, and I'm going to go ahead and put a Twizzler down. And I'll put that Twizzler here, I think. Okay, then obviously I'm going to play this card, which is going to pop that to a 2. And then I will bump my 2 with this 2. No, wait. Oh, my gosh. That I'm going to bump that guy. That guy was already there. Sorry. Because I hibernated my 4. Now I'm going to draw 2 cards and keep them. Do I want to play any cards? Oh, here. That sounds dumb. Yeah, that's a really dumb card. All right, I'm good. Continue on. Look at that. My turn was short, Peter. You can get back to the game now.
That was not. I was almost thinking,
fake,
like, do I need to go and
fake,
boot
fake
up,
news.
Boot up FF7 Rebirth here.
There you go.
On your turn.
Okay, I am going to go here and boot Peter. I'm always booting Peter.
I'm okay with that.
First thing I'm going to do is give James one favor by doing his dance of spending a favor and a point to get 2 points.
So I go up one favor?
Yep.
And I get a card. Interesting.
How many cards are left in this deck? 1?
None.
I don't know.
So we have
none. I literally burned through the deck. So that means the good cards are in there. So if I shuffle it up and I go back there, I could get good cards.
Yes.
Okay. So the second.
That's so broken.
I'm trading. Do I want to do that? Yeah, I'll trade this garbage card. And so I have to flip this and shuffle. So I'm trading it for a better card, hopefully.
I would laugh if you got the same card back again.
I did not. But I don't care for the one I got either. And that is my turn.
Okay. Let's see here. So that's probably not going to happen. I'm not super interested in that happening. So I'm going to trade in a couple of cards for some resources. So 1, 2. Grab a pollen. And what else? And a water, I guess. And tell me if you've seen this one before. I'm going to bump Nathan.
Yeah.
And I am going to lose a queen's favor and spend a pollen. Gain a honey. And I'll lose a point and gain a honey. And what do I got here? I've got it's gonna give me, yeah, I'm gonna play the card that I just got from John and James didn't use, and I will take this one here and set it aside for building purposes at some point.
Was it just one or one of the each?
I think it's just one. Take one face up or.
Yeah, it's a
worse. So it's just one. Yep, so I'll just take that one and we can replace that one.
Although I've seen that being a very valuable card once because of something that everybody wanted.
Yeah, like if there was a really good hex, right?
Yeah.
But I'll just grab that one because I'll probably fairly easily come up with.
All right, my turn then.
Build out. So yeah, John, it's all to you, buddy.
All right. Well, I'm recalling, so I get one hibernation, and not surprisingly, I put it there to get myself a queen's favor, tying Nathan. All right, and then, then these two here come back, and I get two production. Which I will take as...
You're probably not going to like my turn.
Oh, I already know I'm not going to like your turn.
You know what I'm doing?
Two favor. Yeah, I know what you're doing.
Yeah, you know what I'm doing. 14 points.
Unless you're reading one of them wrong. I don't think you know what you're... I don't know if you're...
Well, go take your turn. We'll figure it out if I'm reading it right.
Yeah, I don't think you're reading it right. If you're not doing what I thought you were doing then. All right, okay. Anyway. Yeah, so I got both of those back. So I did two Queen's Favor. And then the other production. What do I need to do things with? I don't need any of that. And what's that going to do for me? Nothing. So, yeah, then I'll just take, no, I can't take that because that'd be counterproductive to the other thing I'm trying to do. So, I'll take, plant fiber and, another favor.
All right. Tell me what that does.
Yeah, I couldn't do that one.
But I can.
Yeah, you can trade in a button.
Basically, yeah, you discard every... Yeah, you can discard a card and get 2 points for each card you discard it that way. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Which will give me 14 points.
I thought you were talking about something else. I was just like, wait, what?
I unfortunately have to get rid of this card first or I would have got 16 points because I need two wax.
Yeah.
And I have the ability that I can take from anywhere in any column. But I will get rid of this water and this water... this water to get my second wax, and then I'm gonna discard all 7 of my cards to give myself 14 points.
Yep. Wait, what is it? What is it that you just did? You just
converted... tile.
Yeah, that tile there.
How many resources did you just convert into waxes?
He converted only two, and he had a wax, right?
I had a card to let me do that.
Yeah. Okay, so you already had a wax. Okay. Because yeah. That card was just do it one time. So I was just checking. Just checking.
So that's 18 points.
Yep.
Nice.
And then I got to place it somewhere. Which I'll place it here. Well, technically, can I, that card that I draw for placing that, can I also discard it?
No, because you've already resolved that card at that point.
Does the card get resolved when...
Oh, you would have drawn it when you resolved that when you placed the tile. So yes, you could discard that card if you want to, yes.
But instead, I'm just going to move myself up to on here.
Yep.
Yep.
Nice.
Okay.
James, are these are the resources that you just spent?
Yeah, I'll put them over there.
All right, just checking.
I want this thing. Which cost me nothing.
Wow, I got rid of a whole bunch of cards I didn't need.
And I get to do... Take two of these explore tokens. And you can place planets there, but I don't get to explore them.
Okay.
I get a point.
And a Twizzler.
And a Twizzler, yes.
I got towels like floating out of nowhere.
I know. Well, I don't know why it's just floating in the middle of the air.
There, I think I got it. Ah, it's still floating.
No, it's still floating. I placed it out there, but it's like it didn't fully load. So it's
It's close enough.
Which one is this one?
Yeah, this Astra for some Astera is floating for some reason. Won't planet? Actually.
Are you all done, Nathan? Is that Peter's turn?
Yeah, is that supposed to be a planet?
It is, yes.
Do we even see what's on? Oh, there it is. Now it loaded.
I tried to place something on it and then it loaded.
Okay. All right. So it's my turn then. I am recalling, which means this guy is going to hibernate.
Now, if I'm looking around here, right, nobody else has a four, correct?
No one
has a four. I'm about to as I recall this three. So I'm going to put it right here, and it becomes a four. And then I need to do one of my things here. So do I want a point? Do I want an extra B-ship thing to put out? Or do I just want three of the Queen's Favor? Where am I on the Queen's Favor track? That would get me up to 4 points. Sure, we'll do that. Yep, that's it for me. So then it is John's turn.
Oh.
We're down to two hibernation spots left.
Yeah. I'm going to go here. Here, what do you have out there, James? You have you just have two twos. Nathan has a three, but yeah.
And Peter has a four, so yeah.
So we are at one there. All right. Yeah. So I'm gonna go here. Here, Peter, gain a favor as I get one honey.
Oh, okay.
And then,
he actually finally did it.
Doesn't really matter. Then, here, Nathan, you also get a favor.
Oh, nice.
Why does Nathan get a favor?
Because he's taking both of our dances.
I'm taking both of your dances.
Oh, you get to do it twice? Oh, you did explore, didn't you?
I did convert.
Okay. He did convert with the number two, so he got to do two things.
Oh, yeah, okay. But why not mine where you get, like, junk cards? You're junk.
You're just total trash.
You're junk.
All right.
It's my B butt.
All right.
No, don't do it. I was joking. That is wrong. All right, you all done?
Yeah, I'm done.
I have a super easy turn. I'm recalling.
All right.
Which will give me another worker. So these will become threes first. Another worker. I'll take that one. And then I will go up one queen's favor. And I'll get a water. Badoom.
Badoom.
Okay. Well, all I got is ones left. So I'm going to convert. So.
Really?
Yep.
Really?
And, nice.
Well, I'm spending my queen's favor and a point to get a point, or 2 points rather, and a card.
Oh, you took your action, James.
And I get a queen flavor. I get the queen's flavor. Yay! And I get my sticks and Twizzlers.
I am using this immediately.
Ooh, what do you get? What do you get? What do you get?
Three resources.
Ooh, to upgrade,
your faction. Sweet.
Nice.
That is pretty awesome.
Let me see what that does. Oh, I get 6 points per adjacent carved tiles. Nice. I wish I could have got more of those. Any cards I want to play yet left? I think I am good.
I think I'm good.
Yeah, you're done?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, John, what are you doing? No. Or no, Peter. I skipped Peter.
Don't do that.
Now that isn't nice. Wait,
what's the movie behind you? So I see Hobbit, which is the cartoon one. I've had that one. Wizard? Oh man, I can't tell. It's a return, King Return. Okay.
So I play my four on the carve. Spend 2 honey.
Now tell me, Peter. Do you also have, by any chance, these?
But I don't know what we're looking at right now. I'm playing a game. Give me a second.
All right, there you go and finish your turn here. Oh, I was about ready to go and buy that.
Yep, I've been waiting to buy it. So I'm gonna,
lost this game, but I'm, whatever.
And that gets me a card. Let's see here.
I was going to buy that just to deny you guys from being able to do that one this turn.
Plant a different. No, that's not going to do anything.
There. Now you don't want to knock them off that spot.
You don't want to do that. What do I need to do with that? I need to discard it for an item. And I need it to be. Yeah, so I'm going to discard that card for a water. All right, that is my turn, and now I will look at whatever it was that John was wanting me to look at.
All right, since we were just
Don't show him. Abort,
see,
abort.
See, somebody also might have bought the movies back in the day, too.
Oh, yeah, no, I do not have those, man.
It's sad that the Hobbit cartoon is infinitely better than the Hobbit movies.
So, James, yes, from left to right in my picture, I have the Hobbit DVD.
Uh-huh.
And then I have the Lord of the Rings DVD,
yeah,
of the animated one,
yeah,
which only covered books 1 and 2 of the trilogy. And then beside that on VHS is the Return of the King,
yeah,
which was animated by the same company that did the Hobbit, but right, finally finished the trilogy.
Yep.
So, all right. It is John's turn.
Yep.
So I took your thing.
Yep.
Well, you didn't have a four anyway.
Yeah, he didn't have a four yet.
Like that.
He could have made one maybe with a card.
Yes, that is correct.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
But now you might not want to bump him.
Yeah, why not? Who else is going to have a four at this point? You're still a ways off from having. Huh? He doesn't have it yet.
Raise a three. I don't know. Quit whining.
I was doing. I'm fine with it.
Whine.
So, do I bump Peter now or not?
I don't care. You can bump me now. You can bump me later. You can not bump me at all. I don't care.
Like, just keep this soundbite. You can bump me now or you can bump me later. I don't care. Bump me anytime you want.
Yeah, at least I deny somebody else that one. So, yeah, I'll do that. So which one am I going to play there for that one? No, I got to do that one. All right. Here, Peter, right. I'm bumping you. All right, so this one right now for this turn is considered to be a four.
All right, so I'm hibernating.
Yep.
It doesn't actually move it up. It's that it's considered a four card.
Yep.
So I go there and I get a water. No, yeah, get a water.
Yeah, Peter almost has nobody left. Where's your last guy at? Is he on your mat? Oh, he's on your mat.
Yeah, sitting on my mat.
Just hanging out.
Since we're getting close to the end, I wanted to comment, make sure you know, when we trigger the end, everybody gets one more turn, including the person who triggered the end.
Correct.
Blah, 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 blah.
All right, but anyway, I'm spending two honey, and I'm taking this one here.
I wanted that one.
Yeah, I know you did. That's why I took it.
Thank you, John.
You all done?
And then I get a card. All right, yeah, I am done right now, yes.
Going here. I draw three cards. To gain three. And then this last one. I will do this. First off, so this refresh. Oh, I have to discard one too, by the way. So I'll discard this one. So I refresh this one, and I get to buy one for one all in less.
I'm surprised you didn't buy like those two guys there that make going to the research give you free resources, and then also let you just return your guy immediately. And
I never said I was good at this game.
Never said I was good at this game, man. Never said it.
I like if you, especially if you can get either of those guys early on. That's just like you never have to explore then at that point because you're good on resources forever.
Oh, wait. That's
and you really get seed cards.
I'm gonna grab that one, which is gonna cost me one honey.
Yep.
Or not one honey. No, give me my honey back. One of these things. Poof. So I can use three strength workers for that. That's pretty cool.
Yep.
I am going to go ahead and play this card. I can spend two resources to activate the four bonus on any face-up planet. I will go ahead and spend this. And a Twizzler. These all get discarded at this point. And I'll activate the one where I think, what is it? The one that, you have to teach a dance and use it twice, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So the people that have been doing this, have you been teaching a dance?
Yes.
Yeah. It's only been done three times.
Total. That's all it can be done.
Yep.
Yep.
So this one's not too bad. So I can't do the dance thing, which sucks. I get to build a plant one for free and trigger its ability. So that means it happens twice. Is that right?
What are you talking about?
This one.
Unless that we've been doing that wrong.
When I build it, it triggers, right?
Yes.
And then I trigger it again.
Unless is it only whenever you do the advance action it triggers?
I don't know. That's so. What I'm asking.
I will double check.
Because if it does, then I'll get that. Otherwise, I might not do that.
I would say we've been doing it that way, so I would just do it that way.
Yeah, because we're really close to the end of the game at this point. I wouldn't change it up now.
Okay. So build one, plant one for free.
But I would like to know for sure.
Buy this one. What? It froze. Oh, okay, there it is. Because that'll give me four. Oh my gosh, it's frozen.
Yeah, we're getting really laggy right now.
All right, right here. And that'll give me four of this. So that'll put me up to 17.
That might be because I was like trying to read through the rules there.
Yeah, probably. All right.
Let me refill the board up here. But that should be the end of me.
Oh, thank the Lord.
Oh my gosh. Don't make me come over there. Big dent. All right. Cool.
Well, I got a dumb turn.
Fantastic. It's the way we like it.
I'm just going to bump myself from convert.
Mm-hmm.
Make that a two. Mainly because I needed a two.
You know what? I would have bumped you probably.
Yeah.
On my turn, but that might have been too long.
It's a horrible conversation. You know what? I would have bumped you.
And I'm gonna.
I'd totally bump that.
A point to a honey.
All right. So that's it for you.
That's him. Then it's my turn. I will take the advance farm action. So that I can go ahead and spend the resources to build the place that I held off in reserve for myself.
Okay.
So that's going to be two Twizzlers and two water.
Oh, Twizzlers. It's always fun.
You mean plant fibers.
And then I'm going to play that right there, which is going to also get me a card. And I'm hoping it's a really good card here at the end of the game. And it is not. All right, that's me.
All right, Nathan, I'm bumping you.
Okay.
And that gives me three conversions, which is going to be three honey. I just have to decide which ways I'm going to get that honey. Let's see.
They're going to lose the queen's favor, or are you going to spend some resources?
If I lose a favor, that's basically like losing half a point. I don't have any water, so I can't do it the normal way.
So you're going to lose three favor and three pollen?
That's the question. Let's see if I get up to 16. Let's see here. That's 7, 8, 9. It's doesn't until it get to 20 does it start getting to be more
amazing. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, because I could actually get some more favor. That's not impossible for me to do here a couple of times actually. Get
four. But you don't have the water, so you're not going to get 3 honey, right?
I'm getting 3 honey, because there's 2 ways to get honey.
Oh, there's lose the points or do that.
Yeah, I can lose points or lose favor. You know what? I'll lose 2 favor and 1 point.
So what's going on? Which one?
And then you'll have to lose 2 pollen too, right?
Yes, if I do that one, yeah. Which... No, I did. Yeah, I'd have to lose 2 pollen that way. Is that, am I okay with that? Yeah, I'm okay with that.
All right, you so all did, done?
Did you use anybody's dances on that one?
I did. So
who did you use?
Peter, you get 2 favor. Nathan gets 1.
All right, I get 2 favor. 2. And Nathan gets 1. All right, awesome.
He's on the board. He's got not 0.
He's got not 0, people.
So I'm bumping that guy, putting that guy here.
I'm not done yet.
He's not done with his turn yet.
Okay.
He's just like you, James. He takes an hour.
All right. I'm going to activate 2 of my farms. So I'm going to get 3 queen's favor right now. Bink.
Okay.
And a plant fiber.
Are you done now?
Yes.
He has like one freaking card left. Okay.
Right, yeah, but I can play it.
James gets three cards.
And I get to keep two.
Yep. Because you're a cad.
All right, we're returning that one, even though it's an awesome card. I am going to increase the strength of this one to four. And then I'm going to pay a resource to play a second ship. So then I'm going to go ahead and pop my four up here to hibernate.
Oh, here we go.
And that will give me a Twizzler.
And that initiates the last round of the game.
Right. So I get another turn, though, too, right? So including the person that ended it, right?
Yes.
So yeah. Then I'm going to draw four. And hopefully get awesome stuff. I have to discard two. There's no point of having you guys at a certain strength anymore, right?
No, not really.
I'm going to have a very basic turn then on my turn. All I'm going to be able to do is recall one person, and that'll be it for me.
I basically can't do anything productive, I think.
I don't know, I guess you could always just convert and get points.
So if I play this card right here, I just get any one of these and it explores, right?
Yeah.
Which is a water. And
you just get a water for it.
Yeah.
And that's it.
That's fine. I get points too, but that's the end game scoring thing. And then I put a little tile out for you guys, see whatever it is.
Rosal. It seems pretty lame planet.
Then I'm good. All right.
All right, Nathan.
I have a good card for you guys.
Last turn, Nathan.
Yeah, I was planning on expanding so I could build more things.
Mm-hmm.
But that's kind of pointless now. So what I think I will have to do... I do have one favor.
Oh, so, I can't plant a card, though, yet. Right, because I can't get that third spot, fourth spot.
Yeah, what happens if you hibernate and it's full?
Correct.
That's what I was asking, because technically I could hibernate, but...
I think you get something.
Yeah. Hibernate and it's full. I think there is a rule for that.
You get 40 points.
No, you probably just get a queen's favor.
You auto lose. No. Yeah, I think
auto lose.
Hibernation. Where's hibernation?
Hmm, okay. That's not bad. I mean, the only one that can hibernate is me anyway, so don't worry about it, I think.
Okay.
We'll figure it out later.
John, you get this three back.
All right.
So he's got a four to spend on his last turn.
Spending a queen's favor and a point. For 2 points, so 1 point more, and a card. Hopefully I get a good and useful card.
Is that's James's dance?
Yes, James.
James, you get queen's favor. You get a queen's favor.
So many things. I have yet to draw. I have not been drawing useful cards for.
I'm okay with that.
I have all these cards, and they do nothing for me.
All right, so your answer is, if you hibernate when there's no spaces left, you get one queen's favor.
Okay.
That's what I thought.
Okay.
You also still put out, like, a, you know, hibernation token, because you still spend one, right? I thought there was, like, a communal pool area you just dump them into.
Yeah, I could be wrong. Like that, I think so.
It wouldn't matter, though, I don't think.
It does matter.
It does?
Yeah.
Why is that?
because somebody might have, you know, something like that.
It doesn't say you do that. You just gain one favor.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, it's...
yep.
All right.
Okay. So, yes. Actually, this is not that bad.
Okay.
This might help.
So, you're going to pay a resource.
Pay a resource.
Move the queen ship one space and explore that location.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Could be good. Oh, queen's favor. Ooh,
queen's favor for no points.
Oh, I didn't finish my... I need to finish this before I do anything more. I'm going to exchange this crap card for a different card. Okay, yeah, sorry.
So your queen's favor should be up to one now.
Yep. My queen's favor is one.
Okay.
I get to take a resource. I will guess I'll take a pollen. Not that that helps. Nope, I'll take it. Well, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
All useless. anything else that's actually useful? None of these cards are useful. That is so disappointing. That did not get me much anything. I guess I'm done. That's my game.
Okay. So I've got a card here that doesn't really do me any good. So then the question is, I can go ahead and get a resource with it. Just resources aren't going to get us anything for like ties or whatever, as far as I know, correct? I'm asking.
Tiebreaker is pretty rare.
Okay. So I'll go ahead and use the card for that. But then I will recall my one worker. And when I recall the worker, I will activate my farm that gets me 3 victory points. So give me a 2 and 9. All right, that's me. I'm done. John?
All right, well, Nathan really helped me out there. So I'm going to bump
myself. I'm sure he did. He gave you that 4.
He gave me that 4. I can't
believe he did that.
Which gives me a carve.
Yep.
And
I didn't get any of those.
Yeah, I can't believe Nathan would give you a 4 to spend on your last turn.
Yep.
Well, it was the only thing that I could get a single point out of.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you gave him a whole lot more than that.
True. I have all this gold that I spent points to get. That's useless.
I get a card. Yep. Ooh. Ooh.
You gonna do it?
Ooh. Yeah, I'm playing cards here. Ooh. All right. Because now I get to play.
Jeez, yeah, that was a lot.
Yeah, here, I just want to. I gotta see it so you can see what I'm now trying to figure out because my things have changed now.
Oh, because you can play another one.
Yeah, I can now play another one. And I just, yep. I bumped myself back, so I got one to play.
And you do have the resources to do it, too.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, your card's so much better than the ones I drew. All
right, but where am I placing this?
Yeah, that's... Because it's not a 4, but yeah, it's not still... a 4.
But, I mean, it's not like I'd do another one of these anyway. And I couldn't teach a dance, and yeah, like really the only thing that 4 would be, it would be giving me 3 points if I went up here, which would be nice,
right?
Man, if I could actually, like,
I was gonna say, you could get 3 more cards, see if the cards do anything for you.
Yeah, I mean, I got 4 more points from a card in my hand.
Oh,
technically,
okay. Gotcha.
If I at least get 1 water from whatever I do here.
Oh, okay. Well, then all you got to do is take the convert action, right? And you can convert other resources.
But I mean, thing is, though, then, like, what am I getting? Like, I'm basically spending 2 points to get 2 points in a card, which that seems silly.
Oh, no, I thought you were trying to say that you need to get water.
Yeah, I need to get water. I mean, I could just spin that card as a water or get water from that whatever I do with that card.
I gotcha. I gotcha. Well, whatever you're doing, let's try to... Well, it's 11 o'clock now, so...
Yep, I'm just taking a look to see what these action ones here, because these are the ones that are really going to be something. You may replace up to two planted. No, I ain't got no planted, so that ain't happening. I don't think actually there's anything I can actually place that does me anything. I mean, I can place here and go somewhere, but I mean, resources don't do anything for me at the end.
No, I mean, there's one more place that we haven't explored yet.
Yeah.
I don't know what's underneath that circle, but
yeah, I don't think that's worth it. I think it's really
convert for points. Convert for points down here.
No, convert what? Convert 2 points into 2 points.
Yeah, we're fine, John. Just do your thing.
All right, all done.
So nope, I could throw that away for water, and then I spend a plant, and then I get to take any one of these up here for free. Sure. Drop this right here beside here. Which then gets me a queen's favor.
Fantastic.
All, right. All done?
Yep. Now I'm done.
Buzz, 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 buzz. I'm going all the way up here. And I'm going to be really super nice to you guys. I get a clay, and then you guys can get a resource, a basic resource of your choice. You're welcome.
Oh, that was nice of you. You've done that earlier.
Am I missing a clay?
You mean a wax?
Wax?
A wax?
Yeah, you don't have any. You have a honey.
Yeah, that's correct.
You have messed up.
Sorry.
I wanted the recollect thing.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell? Well, I'll go down here. I'll bump my own guy, get myself a queen's favor, draw a single card, and hopefully it's amazing.
Did you end up getting the wax for the card that you played just now?
Sure. It doesn't do me any good. I got confused.
Oh, okay.
I thought I had a wax, but I don't. I have a honey.
I gotcha.
And honey's not is only good for that cave thing.
Mm-hmm.
And the card that I got, the worker you place this turn acts as a strength 2. I can't post do it, so it doesn't matter. All right, that's it.
Okay. Right,
that's the game.
I would have got a lot more points if I had one more, whatever that thing is, wax.
Okay, all the points, count up your points on your seed cards and add it to your score.
Sure.
I spawned calculators in case you need them.
Sorry, do what now? Add all the what?
Points from seed cards. So is it just James?
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah.
I'm the only one that got them?
Yeah, you're the only one who planted anything.
Yeah, I was never able to.
Yeah, we used our fours on carves instead.
Yeah.
So that's why you're not that bad off.
All right. Now what?
You can also put them.
Yeah, you can do that. So you got 23 points from yours?
Yep.
And
okay, what's next?
Points on all your tiles on your board.
Points on tiles on boards.
So I'm assuming not the actual like scoring for the yellow ones?
Yeah, yet. Not those yet.
Just the actual printed on scores.
Okay.
Now you do your carve ones, your gold ones.
Oh, what about my base tile one? Not yet?
We haven't done that yet.
Okay. What?
All right, so we're doing the carve ones now?
Yes.
All right, so that's going to be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
All right, I'm going to put myself up to what my current is, and I don't have to worry about it.
Yeah. 49. So right now I need to add 41 to mine.
I can clear this and start over again.
Okay.
After that is Queen's favor.
So that's
Oh, Queen's
nine more for
favor.
me.
Queen's favor.
Okay. When we're...
Okay.
Did you get your
Why does it
Queen's
keep?
favor, James?
I just did that.
Yeah, you
Okay,
know
the
what? These
next.
calculators don't seem to work very well.
Yeah, I quit
No.
using it. I'm
That's.
just using paper.
Oh, yeah. I would just switch to doing it on here. And, like, if I needed to do math using it.
All right, what's next, Nathan?
Now, 8 points for your filling your hive, and then eight more for each expansion you take.
Got it. Okay.
After that, you do your faction bonus.
Faction bonus. Yeah, I didn't do very good on that one. Oh, you guys are actually keeping it on the. Okay, I haven't been doing that. I'm here. Okay.
And then we do majority scoring for
I'm gonna lose the game with that last scoring.
hibernation. So,
Oh wait, wait, no. Where was I at? I was on, shoot, I was on
sorry.
nine.
Yeah.
I didn't add that. I just moved to 68. I needed to add nine
Oh,
to that.
so you're at
So
77 then.
I'm at 77 actually. Okay.
So red and me get 6 points each. And then the second one.
James and I get 4 points each.
Yes.
Okay.
And then 2 more points each
And
for
then
both
two
of you.
more points each.
And that's it. That's the game.
Yep, pretty tight spread there.
But I won.
Yep.
James was all worried he was gonna lose.
I didn't like it's hard. I wasn't really I couldn't I didn't know what you guys were doing. I figured out you got all those gold things and I thought you guys crushed me. But
I
that
mean,
drawing
I'd make it up a lot of points there.
Yeah, that drawing two cards was insane.
Yeah.
Or keeping two cards was insane.
Yeah,
Well,
John, Nathan giving John that four, so he got that monoculture right at the end.
yeah, that was 20 points right there.
That pissed me off so bad.
I
As soon as he
was so happy.
converted, as soon as he converted John to a four, I was like, "You son of a gun! I cannot
Yeah.
believe you just did that."
Yeah, well, here's the thing is I was like, oh man, I just got destroyed by James ending it earlier than I was thinking. Because
You
I
know,
thought I was going
actually,
to get two actions.
it would probably have been better for me just to recall my one worker and get
It would have
3 points.
been. It
Yeah.
would have been. It would have been better for you, would have been better for me, but that's all right. John still didn't win. I can't believe James won.
Yeah, I got so the seeds helped down there, the planted and the seeds, and
Yeah.
then just cycling through those cards. Also, like 14 points in one turn was insane.
Yeah.
Well, if the game had continued any longer, I would have gotten a chance to get one more faction mat, and just every turn I'd be buying
Yet.
my problem
development.
is I wanted to end the game because if you notice, I can't actually build a tile. So like I would have been in a losing game eventually. So I was just like, I need to end it.
Well, that was my problem too. I couldn't build tiles. I needed to build that faction so I can continue
Yeah.
building tiles.
Yeah, here's the thing though is if one of these out here had been a water, I would have gotten 8 more points. Okay, hear you, Nathan. Yeah, that was like none of these providing water, because if I could have placed my worker out here, gotten a
Okay.
water, which would have then allowed me to play that card from my hand to build a tile, I would have had this last one filled out. Actually, it would have been more. That would have been 9 more points for me.
So that was that ended up being a pretty tight game, though. I mean, we're only it's only a 10-point spread from first to last.
Yeah, and the game went like it was pretty easy to learn the game after it got going, you know.
I was really disappointed with all these seed cards I drew. They're not useful for me.
Well, you see that? Remember, I thought.
Oh, no, this would have been great for me because I could have returned to four and it doesn't get bumped.
Yeah.
Yes, but I needed to hibernate more than I needed to return to four.
Yeah. And I had seven, I had eight cards that were generally useless. So that tile coming out was super lucky for me.
Yeah.
So I had a large number of not useful ones, but they're useful in a way all the time. So it's not horrible. Like I could have used it for resources and stuff, but
I didn't need resources the entire game. Really?
Yeah. If I would have known what the cards were and I was actually doing the strategy, I would have gotten so many more points because there's a lot of them that let me replace the planted cards, and for every one I replace I get like 5 points.
Wait,
and I didn't realize that this cycled through so fast.
Well, you get five points?
Yeah, there's a card there that you'll get 5 points if you replace your planted card.
Oh, I have one that allows you to replace your planted card, but it didn't give me any points for it.
Yeah,
or if James would have played that one that gave him a clay, you know, earlier, so I could have had a water on my turn.
Yeah, that would have helped out. Yeah, I wanted to make sure I didn't use that till my turn. But then the honey looked like a clay to me, or wax, I mean, and I got confused. I would have got a lot of points if it was a wax, but it wasn't.
Yep.
So, oh well. I never, ever got a gold tile, though.
Yeah, I had three plants. If just one of those plants had been a water instead, like, yeah, there's probably somewhere I probably wasted a water when I could have wasted a plant instead, fiber. And that would have been the game for me there.
Yeah. But yeah, overall, I think this game's great. I want to play it again. I think the real copy would be a lot better because I hate TTS. Yeah.
It is. Plus, also getting a lot of those other extra factions is really cool. Because like some of them have a lot more unique. Also, like the other extra player boards, you then have enough where you can actually give everybody two of them and they get to pick what one.
Oh, that's
want.
Cool.
Yeah.
Is there any expansions out for this? It's just the main game, right? I don't think there's an expansion yet.
No, so. there's just like the other one, like the other non-basic faction tiles. And there's extra. Is there extra boards? I thought there was extra boards.
I don't think there's. I don't think it came out with extra boards, but it definitely came out with a lot more.
Actually, I'm not sure if there was now or not. But yeah, here's the other things. Yeah, we actually had them. We could have, instead of each of us just taking one starter faction, we could have also drawn one of these extra ones and had like a choice between them. And you can see a lot of these have like a lot more advanced kind of starting and like abilities.
All right. So this is the most important part. Flipping of the table.
Oh,
he just got the lowest score.
So yeah, I got low score, so I will flip.
You get to destroy.
If it actually does a good flip.
Probably won't.
Probably not.
We've had one.
Nope.
Oh, super lame. Weak. That's, oh my gosh. I can't even look at it.
I know.
All right, you know what? That is so weak. I'm just going to rewind that. In
can't
fact,
stand it.
There's
such a really good table flip animation. I don't know why they don't all do that.
Yep. Table skill. I don't know.
Who cares?
Well,
that was fun.
I'm with you guys. I thought it was a really good game. I liked it quite a bit. And I would definitely play that one again.
Yep. And to all you out there, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this game and my epic win. I devastated everyone. They were crying at the end.
I don't know if
grown men who have never cried in their entire life were crying with my win there. It was amazing. It was spectacular. It'll blow your mind how much that I have won tonight. So thank you for watching, and I hope you all have a good night.